Economics would like to welcome you all for the 5 days faculty development program on Moodle Learning Management System. A learning management system is a software application used for the administration, documentation, tracking, reporting, automation, and delivery of educational courses and training programs. The current pandemic situation has indeed enrouted us to the importance of adapting ourselves to the digital mediums such as LMS to impart education. May I now request our principal, Dr. Shrikant P. Savant, to speak a few words.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. Good evening. And a very warm welcome to you.
Good evening,
all.
Sir.
For this faculty development program on Moodle Learning Management System begins from today, 8 June to 14 June 2020. I take proud privilege to welcome our dignitaries and guests, our resource persons, Professor Ranjan Kumar, Integral University, Lucknow, Professor Jatin Ambasana, Marwari University, Rajkot, Professor Satya Prakash Singh, Director, City School of Pharmacy, Barabanki, Professor Maulik Trivedi, Darshan Institute of Engineering and Technology, Rajkot, Professor Devyan Bhattacharya, and Dr. Anup Sarbaya, a team of expertise. This team of expertise will guide us, their scholarly guidance and perfect demonstration of these expertise will give our teachers hands-on practice on Moodle LMS. Our teachers will get a better grip on how to manage online teaching learning processes. The 7-day schedule of FDP is already given, wherein on 11th and 12th June, we have self-practice and hands-on activities. We are receiving trainings after trainings, which will make us to be competent online teachers ready to face the challenges of time. I appreciate the positive response of our teachers and their quest for learning on new modes, methods. The teachers are ready to accept change and taking interest in learning on new methods, new vistas. I'm also thankful to our management, Chikitsak Samoha, for availing this new platform for online teachers teaching learning. I express my sincere thanks to Sri Rangnekar Sir, President, Dr. Sri Rajesh Desai, Vice President, Dr. Gurunath Pandit, and Joint Secretary, and all the office bearers of Chikitsak Samoha for their strong support and consistent encouragement in conducting these new activities. I must extend welcome and thanks to Dr. Mala Kharkar, CEO, and the team ICT, especially Bhushan and others, for organizing and designing this faculty development program, which is a need of an hour. Once again, I would like to welcome you all in this realms of knowledge, which will surely lead us to wisdom. Thank you. Now over to Kajal.
Thank you, sir. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome our speakers for today and forthcoming sessions. Professor Jatin Ambasana, Assistant Professor at Marwari University, Rajkot. Professor Maulik Trivedi, Darshan Institute of Engineering Technology, Rajkot. Dr. Anup Sirbaya, Associate Professor with Integral University, Lucknow. Professor Debayan Bhattacharya, Assistant Professor at Future Institute of Technology, Kolkata. Dr. Satya Prakash Singh, Professor and Director with the City School of Pharmacy, Barabanki, Uttar Pradesh. Professor Ranjan Kumar, Assistant Professor, Integral University, Lucknow. Today's session on Moodle Introduction, Installation, and Administration will be delivered by Professor Maulik Trivedi and Professor Jatin Ambasana. Introducing to you our today's speaker. Professor Maulik Trivedi has done his M.Tech in Computer Science and Engineering from Nirma University, Ahmedabad in 2012 and has been associated with the Darshan Institute of Engineering and Technology, Rajkot, since July 2009. Mr. Maulik is a life member of the Indian Society for Technical Education. Currently, Sir is also the Moodle exam system coordinator for his institute. Mr. Jantin Ambasana is working as assistant professor at Computer Engineering Department, Marwari University, Rajkot, and has 10 years of experience in teaching, including about 2 years of experience in the software industry. Sir has been associated with IIT Bombay as a teaching associate towards the successful completion of the 2-week digital transformation in the teaching and learning process course organized by NPIU and conducted by IIT Bombay on Swayam from January 2020 to April 2020. He has also contributed in various faculty development programs and workshops. Introducing you all to our resource persons for the discussion forum. Dr. Anup Kumar Sarbaya. Dr. Anup Kumar Sarbaya is currently working as an associate professor with Integral University, Lucknow, with an experience of about 17 years. He is a certified STEM teacher on research-based pedagogical tools from Center of Excellence in Science and CR Pune under MHRD Government of India. Sir is also certified by IIT Bombay for designing and implementing online and blended courses, better use of ICT in education, video content creation, mentoring, and other related topics through various courses. He has also acted as a resource person and coordinated various FDPs. Our next resource person, Professor Debayan Bhattacharya, has 7 years of teaching experience. He has completed his M.Tech in Electrical Engineering from the Sir is a lifetime member of the Institute of Engineers and has developed a flair in the field of educational technology. He became one of the top performers of FDP 101X and acted as an associate faculty mentor for FDP 201X and FDP 301X, offered by the Department of Educational Technology, IIT Bombay. Professor Debayan has acted as a discussion forum moderator for DTI-TLP course organized by IIT Bombay and NPIU under TEQIP. Sir, it is a great pleasure to have you all with us. I would now hand over the session to Maulik, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Am I audible?
Welcome, sir.
Am I audible, ma'am?
You are audible.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir,
good evening to all. Yeah, good evening to all. Actually, I know that during this situation, so we are at remote place and we not at get together at one place and learning this course together. So with help of online Moodle, online Google Meet options, we learn at Moodle LMS systems. And actually, Moodle LMS systems helps you to learning at online course education purpose. So my role is in Moodle installation is to install an administrative part and how it installed on server or workstation. So what kind of prerequisite software to be installed, what kind of configuration to be done. So my deliver medium is can be English or Hindi. Can I English or Hindi both? So other can also understand what kind I'm saying that, right?
Yes, sir, you can go. Madam ma'am had allowed us for that. You can go ahead with that.
Yeah. Yeah, so everyone can. Somebody sharing his screen. Okay. Yeah, visible my screen?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Yes, sir, yes, sir. Visible.
Yeah, so go with the Moodle installation. First of all, what is Moodle? Actually, Moodle is nothing. It's a world most popular learning management system, and mostly creating online learning site in a minute. We can say in a minute after installation of administrative site. So the role of administrator is more on this side because they need to install the various software. So administrator ko thoda isme zyada role dena padega kyunki installation part isme thoda time consuming hai. After installation done, the user can use this learning platform, this management system easily. So let's we learn, create and manage the course on Moodle. But before going, we just watch the learning part. What we learn in today's session as well as the throughout the FDB. The first session is Moodle introduction, installation and administrative part. Then after we will learn course and user management, then peer interaction, communication and assignments. Then after we will do some practice, hands-on activity and then the progress tracking and gamification. So these are the learning path. Now I'm going to actual concept, the Moodle installation and administration. So Moodle administration or installation based on the two things. The first thing is cloud based. So we can say it's a internet based. So you can use it with Gnomeo. Means you can say it's Gnomeo website, gnomeo.com. You can create your own website which will be covered on later days. And I mean, I'm covering this part in LAN or intranet. Suppose aap apne institute mein work kar rahe ho, apne institutes mein local area network aur intranet mein agar aap Moodle install karna chahte ho, aur wo Moodle installation sabhi department, sabhi students ko access karna hai, to mujhe teen options milenge. First option se Linux server se main install kar sakta hun, second option se Windows server mein main install kar sakta hun, aur second option hai which are rarely used, iMac और Mac machine में use कर सकता हूँ. I recommended you choose Linux server, either CentOS, either Linux Mint or Ubuntu server. Second option is Windows server. Windows server is useful, but licensing issue are there. So if you have Windows licensing, then this is recommended. You can use Windows 2012-2013 server. In next PPT, next slide, I will show you the how to install in Linux or Windows. If time there, then I will show you in Mac installation. So we need prerequisite software. हमको पहले से ये software install करना पड़ेगा Moodle के online course access करने से पहले. So first we need to install any observer. जो सर्वर में हम अपना मूडल का कोर्स मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम है वो होस्ट करेंगे. सो लोकल मशीन में हम क्या करेंगे कि एक सर्वर इंस्टॉल करेंगे. वो सर्वर का नाम है अपाचे सर्वर. उसके साथ एक डेटाबेस चाहिए, तो डेटाबेस हम यूज करेंगे MySQL डेटाबेस विथ PHP. सो अगर हम लिनक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम यूज करते हैं तो हमको लैम्प इंस्टॉल करना पड़ेगा, और अगर हम विंडोज यूज करते हैं तो हमको लैम्प की बजाय जैम्प यूज करना पड़ेगा. और वी नीड एनी मॉडर्न ब्राउजर लाइक गूगल क्रोम एंड मोजिला फायरफॉक्स. सो यूजिंग दिस ब्राउजर वी कैन एक्सेस द मूडल कोर्स सिस्टम. नाउ मिनिमम हार्डवेयर रिसोर्स वी रिक्वायर्ड. सो इफ यूजर्स आर अंडर 50 और 15 टू 100 स्टूडेंट्स, देन मिनिमम i5 कॉन्फ़िगरेशन प्रोसेसर सीपीयू एंड मिनिमम 100 GB हार्ड डिस्क स्पेस. So you need to take a backup as well as the content and course details likewise. And one more thing, the RAM should be 8 GB. So 8 GB RAM, 100 GB hard disk, i5 minimum CPU processor is required. Suppose user's size is more than 100, then only change to in RAM capacity. Instead of 8 GB, you can use 16 GB. In our institute, I have used 32 GB i7 processor and 100 GB hard disk. It's sufficient to 1300 plus students, right? And at a time we can take exam of 300 plus students. Next, I will show the installation part. Actually, it is not feasible ke aapke wahan pe jo aapka jo server hai wo main access yahan pe nahi kar sakta. So that's why I make a video, and this video will be put on the YouTube. How to install, जो कैसे इंस्टॉल लिनक्स सर्वर पे होता है वो मैं वीडियो के थ्रू आपको एक्सप्लेन कर दूंगा. दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट. यू कैन वॉच पॉज एंड लर्न, वॉच पॉज एंड लर्न. दिस इज द मेथड टू लर्न. दिस पार्ट, वॉट इज द कोर्स विच विल बी सीन लेटर आफ्टर द इंस्टॉलेशन पार्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हम क्या करेंगे, हम पहले मूडल का रिसोर्स डाउनलोड करेंगे. मूडल का रिसोर्स डाउनलोड करने के लिए वी नीड टू ओपन ब्राउजर एंड डाउनलोड द मूडल. ये मूडल की वेबसाइट से, यहां से हम डायरेक्टली मूडल का सोर्स डाउनलोड कर लेंगे. मूडल का सोर्स तीन तरह का मिलेगा हमको. सी, दिस इज द लेटेस्ट वर्जन ऑफ द मूडल. मूडल की वेबसाइट पे ये मूडल इंस्टॉलेशन पैकेज है मैक ओएस के लिए, मूडल इंस्टॉलेशन पैकेज है विंडोज के लिए. अगर हम लिनक्स सर्वर यूज करेंगे तो ये पैकेज यूज करना होगा. देयर आर टू ऑप्शन, .tzz ऑप्शन, सो यू कैन डाउनलोड इट सिमिलर लाइक zip, एंड ऑल्सो zip इज ऑप्शन अवेलेबल. इंडिविजुअली यू कैन यूज मूडल इंस्टॉल पैकेज विंडोज. अगर आप घर पे अपने लैपटॉप में और अपने पीसी में मूडल इंस्टॉल करना चाहते हैं तो आप ये पैकेज डाउनलोड करके इंस्टॉल कर सकते हैं. वो मैं लिनक्स इंस्टॉलेशन के बाद आपको बता दूंगा कि कैसे विंडोज में आप मूडल इंस्टॉल इंडिविजुअली कर सकते हैं, अपने लोकल मशीन में कैसे विंडोज के थ्रू मूडल एक्सेस कर सकते हैं. दिस आर द लेटेस्ट रिलीज वर्जन 3.8.3. There are lots of versions are available. Before going to install Moodle or before going to configuration Moodle, we need a web server as I told with PHP and a database. So we also need to download PHP with web server and database. We are using LAMP server for Linux and MySQL for the database purpose. You can also use the MariaDB as a database. So, मैं ये इंस्टॉलेशन जो डाउनलोड की जो लिंक है वो आपको एंड ऑफ द सेशन रिसोर्स जो फोल्डर दिया गया है आपके LMS सिस्टम, अगर आप लॉग इन करेंगे वो सर जतिन सर आपको बताएंगे कि कैसे वो पूरा मॉडल सिस्टम आपको एक्सेस करना है. उसके फोल्डर में ये टेक्स्ट फाइल में मैं ये लिंक डाल दूंगा कि आप कहाँ से ये LAMP सर्वर और ZAMP सर्वर और ये सब डेटाबेस डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं. Apache MySQL and PHP server. Now we are going to download this zip file. These are the different version. This is the first version 3.8.3 plus the second version. So I have download zip file. See, in that the requirement prerequisite software list are available. See, that I told you. Now download this zip file.
Excuse me, Maulik sir, sorry to interrupt you, but there are few participants who cannot hear you and see you. So can you repeat the point again?
Okay, no issue, ma'am.
There might be some network problem, so they might not hear you.
Okay, I will explain from the अगर आपको अपने लैपटॉप और पीसी में ये मॉडल इंस्टॉलेशन सेटअप करना है तो प्री रिक्विजिट सॉफ्टवेयर इंस्टॉल करना पड़ेगा लाइक वेब सर्वर विथ पीएचपी एंड ए डेटाबेस विथ माई एसक्यूएल. यू कैन ऑल्सो इंस्टॉल MariaDB एज ए डेटाबेस. सो दिस वेबसाइट download.moodle.org इज हेल्पफुल टू डाउनलोड द मॉडल पैकेज. As well as you can also download this web server with PHP and database from this link, obtaining Moodle via Git. So, मैं आपको ये सब installation की link आपको resource में दे दूंगा. Here, this software will be required. Now I am downloading this zip file for the Moodle configuration.
Sir, I would suggest you can switch off your video so that the bandwidth does not get much. You can switch off your camera.
Yeah. Jatin sir, is it visible for the all things?
Yes, yes, it is visible. Yes, now it is visible and your video has also been made off. No issue. Now you can continue. Your screen is visible.
Okay, I also... So after downloading this package, you can access the Moodle from your browser, but before that you need to configure that person. So yeah, we need to write localhost, means apne PC ka naam likhna hai. So yahan se hum Moodle access kar sakte hai, but the message display unable to connect because we have not started the server. So before first to be take care about these steps, you need to start a server. After that, the Moodle is on for the all. Now for that, I need to start a server. I have started server. In that PHP local myadmin, these are the database. In that I have used our database, so Apache plus MariaDB and PHP we required. Installation ke baad हम यहाँ पे अपना मॉडल की जो वेबसाइट का जो नाम रखना चाहते हैं वो यहाँ पे हम सेट कर सकते हैं, विच विल बी कवर्ड लेटर, बट ऐसे होगा. Now, after the starting the this server, we need to configure Moodle. So for that, I need to I write the Moodle, then enter, that it gives the this windows. In that I have set this localhost / Moodle. So I am using this name as a my website's name, Moodle directory, which will be directly comes data directory. Then after you need to next, then फोन आई होता है ना फोन कर ही देना सो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव साइड यहाँ पे हम ये इंस्टॉल करेंगे उसमें एक एरर आएंगी वो डायरेक्टरी आपको क्रिएट नहीं करने देगा सम ऑफ पीसी गिव्स द एरर बिकॉज द राइट परमिशन इज यू सो क्या करना होगा अगर आप लिनक्स सिस्टम यूज करते हैं तो टर्मिनल में जाके chmod के कमांड के थ्रू ये जो लैम्प का फोल्डर है और ये मूडल का फोल्डर जो आप इंस्टॉल करने वाले हैं वो फोल्डर को आप परमिशन दे देंगे अगर आप विंडोज सिस्टम यूज करने वाले हैं तो विंडोज में भी परमिशन का ऑप्शन है वहां पे एवरीवन रीड एंड राइट का ऑप्शन आपको एनेबल करना होगा सो द मूडल डायरेक्टरी कैन बी क्रिएट द डायरेक्टरी मूडल डेटा Then onwards, yeah. Afterwards, यहाँ पे हम डेटाबेस क्रिएट करने वाले हैं डेटाबेस होस्ट नेम और डेटाबेस का नेम क्रिएट करने वाले हैं जहां पे हमारा मूडल का सब सेटिंग्स कोर्स कंटेंट वगैरह स्टोर होगा सो इन दैट आई नीड टू क्रिएट अ डेटाबेस यूजर एज अ रूट डेटाबेस पासवर्ड आई सेट माय ओन पासवर्ड देन नो नीड टू चेंज इन दिस टेबल प्रीफिक्स डेटाबेस पोर्ट एंड यूनिक सॉकेट I am setting the name, database name, password, users, and then click next. Clicking, it will give the confirmation message. Are you confirm using these users? Then installation will be start after pressing the continue. See, these are the installation steps which will be installed by Moodle. In PHP, in XAMPP server. So यहाँ पे अगर आप इंस्टॉल करोगे तो आपको तीन टाइप की एरर दिखाई देंगी अगर ये जो येलो कलर का आता है तो मीन्स इट ओके है कोई इश्यू नहीं है यहाँ पे ऑरेंज कलर का कोई ऑप्शन आता है यहाँ पे अगर आपको ये अलग कलर कोडिंग दिखाई दे रहा होगा अगर आप इंस्टॉलेशन करोगे तो यहाँ पे ये येलो आएगा ये ऑरेंज आएगा और जो एरर दिखाई हो देगी वो आपको रेड कलर की दिखाई देगी ये जो ऑरेंज कलर का है वो आपको यहाँ पे चेक लिखा हुआ होगा सो ये आपको कॉन्फ़िगरेशन में चेंज करना है ये चेंज करने के बाद ही आपका कॉन्फ़िगरेशन इंस्टॉलेशन सेटअप आगे जाएगा सो यहाँ पे एक ये रेड कलर की जो एरर दिखाई दे रही है यहाँ पे एरर है कि आपका डेटाबेस टाइप कौन सा यूज कर रहे हो मैंने क्या किया था मैंने अपने वर्क स्टेशन और मेरे सर्वर में MySQL इंस्टॉल किया था और यहाँ पे ये MariaDB यूज कर रहा है सो ये चेंजेस क्या आ रहा है कि config.php में जाके आपको ये MySQL के बजाय MariaDB लिखना है ये डेटाबेस एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर होगा वो खुद समझ सकता है कि कॉन्फ़िगरेशन फाइल में कौन सा डेटाबेस हम यूज कर रहे हैं उसका नाम सिर्फ यहाँ पे मेंशन करना है सो अगर हम config.php में जाके MySQL के बजाय MariaDB लिखेंगे तो ये एरर चली जाएंगी और ये क्वेश्चन एक अभी आएगा कि config.php क्या है ये config.php आप जो मॉडल इंस्टॉल करोगे, जो zip फाइल डाउनलोड किया है उसको एक्सट्रैक्ट करोगे, तो जो फोल्डर मिलेगा आपको एक्सट्रैक्शन का मॉडल फोल्डर है, उसमें ये फाइल model.php होंगी, वहां पे आप चेंज कर सकते हैं। सो आफ्टर चेंजेस दिस ऑप्शन यू कैन रिफ्रेश दिस पेज अगेन। सो ये एरर आपको यहां से चली जाएंगी और ये ओके स्टेटस में आ जाएंगी। फिर एक एरर ये आपको ये मिलेगी कि ये डेटाबेस एंटेलोप फाइल फॉर्मेट यूज कर रहा है। जो MySQL और PHP अच्छी तरह से जानता है उसको पता होगा कि ये MySQL एंटेलोप फाइल फॉर्मेट यूज कर रहा है, और जो MariaDB है वो बाराकूडा ऑप्शन सेट कर रहा है, बाराकूडा फाइल फॉर्मेट यूज कर रहा है। सो हमको क्या करना है कि भाई ये हमारा फाइल फॉर्मेट है वो एंटेलोप से बाराकूडा फाइल फॉर्मेट सेट करना पड़ेगा अगर हम MariaDB डेटाबेस यूज करते हैं तो। उसके लिए हमको 3-4 क्वेरी है वो डेटाबेस में रन करनी होगी, जो जिसका सॉल्यूशन मॉडल की वेबसाइट में ही दिया गया है। लेट अस सी, आई एम ओपनिंग docs.moodle.org, उसमें ही मुझको ये MySQL का फुल सपोर्ट दिया गया है, उसमें ही मुझे दिया गया है कि ये SQL कमांड में रन करूंगा, ये क्वेरी में रन करूंगा, सो क्या होगा कि भाई मैं MariaDB डेटाबेस यूज कर सकता हूं इंस्टेड ऑफ MySQL डेटाबेस फॉर्मेट से। ये हम कॉपी कर लेते हैं और लोकल होस्ट जहां पे मैंने इंस्टॉल किया है PHP MyAdmin, वहां पे SQL ऑप्शंस में जाके यहां पे मैं पेस्ट कर दूंगा। सी PHP लोकल होस्ट देन PHP MyAdmin एंड दिस इज माय डेटाबेस नेम bmoodle। So in that I am going to SQL options, then I will this query. Don't forget to put semicolon end of the this query, otherwise it will create an error. Then press go. So it run, execute, and your database affected means database query will be affected. Now then you can refresh the installation. You will see the message, your server environment meets all minimum requirements. So then you can continue with this option. Then after it will take a time approximately half an hour. If you're using good server, then it will take half an hour. If you're using average hardware configuration, then it will take a 1 hour. So I will be skip this part, just showing how to database update. See, यहाँ से पूरा डेटाबेस अपडेट और इंस्टॉल हो रहा है। After completing, the continue button is enabled, so you can press continue. See, this is the installation window. In that, you need to set username, means administrator username. Administrator have all the rights to create a course, create a role, create a category, create a quiz, all the stuffs. Administrative also give the rights to the user, other user like teacher, student, manager. So this is the super user which handle the all things of Moodle systems. Yeah, I have set the username admin. creating a password for the admin user. Email address admin@gmail.com. You can enter at your email address, city, town, country, time zone, which will important to set over here. Yes, yeah. In description part, see, in description part, you can write your Moodle system information. What is Moodle LMS system? Then, these are the additional things which you need to input: your web page, your Skype ID, your Yahoo ID, MSN ID, likewise, your institute name, department, phone number, contact, address, all the stuff. Update your profile. After that, yeah, after updating the profile, this is the setting for the front page setting. Means अगर आपका जो मूडल ओपन होगा, फर्स्ट यूआरएल आप ओपन करेंगे लोकल होस्ट स्लैश मूडल, देन फ्रंट पेज कैसा आएगा, उसमें कौन सा नाम लिखा होगा, कौन सा डिटेल्स दिया गया होगा, फ्रंट पेज में कौन से ब्लॉग दिए गए होंगे, वो सेटिंग यहां से हम कर सकते हैं। यहां पे आपको फुल साइट नेम लिखना है। मैं आपको डेमो दूंगा, अपनी कॉलेज का मैंने कैसे सेट किया है वो आपको एक बार डेमो दे दूंगा, इसलिए आपको पता चल जाएगा कि भाई कैसे फ्रंट पेज दिखाई दे रहा है। यहाँ पे मैंने फुल साइट नेम लिखा है, यू कैन एंटर डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ योर फ्रंट पेज, टाइम जोन यू नीड टू सेट एशिया कलकत्ता, then manage the authentication. You can authentication or registration by default it disable होता है, आपको email के through भी registration करवाना हो तो यहाँ पे option आ जाएगा। हमारे जो Nomio site में registration की procedure है वो जतिन सर after this session आपको बताएंगे कि कैसे आपको register करना है, कैसे आपको उसको use करना है। So या आउटगोइंग मेल कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, अगर यहाँ से मूडल से आपको कोई एक मेल करना है तो आपको यहाँ पे मेल कॉन्फ़िगरेशन में वो ईमेल एड्रेस आपको डालना पड़ेगा, जो मैंने एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर का यूज किया था वही मैं यहाँ पे यूज कर रहा हूँ। सेव कर लेता हूँ पूरा कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, देन इट विल शो द डैशबोर्ड, एक्चुअल मूडल वेबसाइट का डैशबोर्ड आ गया है। यहाँ पे मुझे क्या मिलेगा, मेरा जो शॉर्टकट मैंने जो नेम लिखा है वो पूरा नेम मिलेगा, यहाँ पे मेरा साइट होम मिलेगा, ये मेरा डैशबोर्ड है, यहाँ पे पूरा कैलेंडर आएगा, यहाँ पे मैं अपना कोर्स इनपुट कर सकता हूँ। फॉर एग्जांपल मेरे इंस्टीट्यूट में फर्स्ट ईयर है तो मैंने एक कोर्स एक कैटेगरी डाली है फर्स्ट ईयर कैटेगरी, देन मैंने कोर्स क्रिएट किया है कंप्यूटर, अनदर कैटेगरी डालता हूँ कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग, देन मैंने एक कोर्स डाला है मैथ फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री लाइकवाइज। सो मैं वो आपको अभी दिखा रहा हूँ कि कोर्स कैसे क्रिएट करते हैं यहाँ पे और यूजर कैसे हैंडल करते हैं। सी यहाँ पे मैं एक कोर्स क्रिएट करूंगा, यहाँ पे हमें कोर्स के नेम और उसकी विजिबिलिटी शो करनी है कि हाइड करनी है वो मैं सेट कर सकता हूँ। कोर्स की स्टार्ट डेट और एंड डेट सेट कर सकता हूँ। कोर्स का आईडी देना होगा वो यूनिक होगा और कोर्स का डिस्क्रिप्शन डिस्क्रिप्शन पार्ट में देना होगा। कोर्स की अगर कोई इमेज कोई आइकॉन है तो यहाँ पे मैं अपलोड कर सकता हूँ। कोर्स का फॉर्मेट अपीयरेंस फाइल अपलोड दीज आर द ऑप्शनल डिटेल यू कैन गो थ्रू इट। नाउ माई कोर्स इज क्रिएटेड एज ए मैच। दूसरा कोई कोर्स क्रिएट करना है तो यहां से मैं कोर्स क्रिएट करूंगा। अगर मुझे इस कोर्स में दूसरी कोई चीज एंटर करनी है और वहां पे कोर्स में यूजर को एनरोल करना है, सी साइड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर ऑप्शन से मुझे यूजर्स मिलेंगे। यूजर्स का डिटेल्स हम अपकमिंग डेज में हम देखेंगे कि यूजर कैसे क्रिएट करते हैं, यूजर कैसे अपलोड करते हैं। यहाँ पे सी कैसे यूजर्स को हम यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं, कैसे बल्क यूजर एक्शन कर सकते हैं, न्यू यूजर आए तो यूजर कैसे ऐड कर सकते हैं, यूजर अगर हमको अपलोड यूजर करने हैं एक साथ 100 यूजर, कोई एक क्लास है कोई एक क्लास का 100 स्टूडेंट्स है तो एक साथ उसको कैसे अपलोड कर सकते हैं, उसका ऑप्शन भी दिया गया है कि अपलोड यूजर। तो उसका एक पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मेट दिया गया है, वो पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मेट सी अपलोड यूजर में एक पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मेट यहाँ पे दिया गया है कि example.csv करके, वहां पे आप अपना स्टूडेंट्स के यूजर को अपलोड कर सकते हैं। उसका पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मेट अपलोड करके डायरेक्टली ऑल यूजर को एक्सेस दे सकते हैं। नाउ फॉर द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव साइड एक इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव साइड से जो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। मूडल मैंने सॉफ्टवेयर इंस्टॉल कर लिया, मूडल कॉन्फ़िगर भी मैंने कर लिया, मूडल का कोर्स भी मैंने क्रिएट कर लिया, क्विज भी क्रिएट कर ली, यूजर भी क्रिएट कर लिया। ये मूडल हम डे बाय डे यूज करेंगे, लेकिन मेंटेन कैसे करेंगे? अगर कोई इश्यू आया, कोई डेटाबेस क्रैश हो गया तो क्या करना होगा? तो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव पार्ट से ये एक इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेप है जो एवरी डे फॉलो करना है। इट मस्ट फॉलो एवरी डे टू बैकअप योर मूडल डेटाबेस। सो फॉर दैट यू नीड टू टेक ए बैकअप फ्रॉम पीएचपी माय एडमिन साइट। सो ये अपना डेटाबेस नेम है डी मूडल। इन दैट सी ये अपने सारे टेबल्स है जहां पे अपने मूडल कोर्स कंटेंट डिटेल्स वगैरह हमने रखे गए हैं। तो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर क्या करेगा, नेटवर्क एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर ये मूडल के डेटाबेस में जाएगा, उसमें अपना जो डेटाबेस है उसको एक्सपोर्ट करेगा। सी दीज आर द टेबल, एक्सपोर्ट करेगा। एक्सपोर्ट करने के लिए यहाँ पे एक ऑप्शन दिया गया है क्विक विच इज मिनिमल ऑप्शन और एक कस्टम मीन्स यू कैन टेक एनी ऑफ द टेबल बट बाय डिफॉल्ट क्विक ऑप्शन में सारे टेबल का डेटाबेस को बैकअप ले सकते हैं, सारे टेबल का बैकअप हम ले सकते हैं। और हम यहाँ से फॉर्मेट डिसाइड करेंगे कौन सा फॉर्मेट लेना है बैकअप के लिए। सो बाय डिफॉल्ट एसक्यूएल फॉर्मेट इज सुटेबल एंड रिकमेंडेड।
सर यू हैव मिस्टेकनली प्रेजेंटेड योर स्क्रीन।
सॉरी, हेलो
गौतम सर हैज प्रेजेंटेड द स्क्रीन, सो गौतम सर कैन press the stop presenting.
Yeah,
it will go.
Gautam sir stop kara the presenting stop kara.
Okay, thank you sir. Malik sir,
okay, done.
Yes sir,
can
sir.
I continue?
Yes sir. Malik sir, I would suggest you please if possible on your side then try to zoom in so that people can see what options you are using, right? If it is possible on your side.
Yeah. It's okay now.
I'm not able to see the PowerPoint.
Right? Now it's visible?
No.
Yes, sir, it is visible. It is visible, but to those to whom it is not visible, they please click on the presentation icon of Professor Maulik. Maulik sir's two name will be there. One will be Professor Maulik and another will be presentation. So just pin it. There is something called as pin. So that pin, when you pin it, that that video will only be shown. If by mistake you pin someone else, then someone else's photo or video will be shown and sir's presentation will not be shown on your side. So just take care not to pin someone. Okay.
Yeah, also I'll share the YouTube link so you can view the video after the session. So it is easy.
Yes, sir. I've already shared it in the Moodle. It has been shared.
Okay. So the backup ke liye humko ek quick option select karke yahan se SQL format select karke backup lena hai. So it's recommended and it must perform every day, end of the day. After that, एक ये आपको इम्पोर्टेंट है, ये आपको बताना होगा एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव साइड से. ये जो हम मॉडल इंस्टॉल करेंगे उसका क्या होगा कि भाई ये हम लैन में यूज करेंगे, जहां पे लोकल एरिया नेटवर्क होगा वहां पे ही ये एक्सेस कर सकते हैं. क्योंकि यहाँ पे क्या है कि भाई हमने ये सेटअप लोकल होस्ट लोकल सर्वर मशीन में ही किया है. अगर हमको ये एक्सेस करना है आउटसाइड ऑफ द कैंपस और आउटसाइड ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी, देन व्हाट टू डू, देन वी नीड टू सेट अवर लाइव आईपी एड्रेस ओवर हियर. अगर आपके इंस्टीट्यूट में कोई लाइव आईपी एड्रेस जो आपको दिए गए है प्रोवाइडर के द्वारा, जो लाइव आईपी एड्रेस यहाँ पे आप सेट कर सकते हैं. और अगर आप फायरवॉल यूज कर रहे हैं, अगर आप साइबर रोम नाउ इट्स सोफोस और एनी ऑफ द फायरवॉल यू कैन यूज, देन आपको वो फायरवॉल में से ये आउटगोइंग लिंक जो जा रही है ये आईपी एड्रेस आउट लिंक की, उसको बाईपास करना होगा. सो क्या उससे क्या होगा कि भाई आउटसाइड ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी कैंपस एरिया के बाहर भी स्टूडेंट ये आपकी मॉडल की लिंक एक्सेस कर सकते हैं. सो दिस इज द ऑप्शन. और ये फाइल कहाँ पे होगी, ये लिनक्स अगर आप यूज करेंगे तो लिनक्स में फाइल सिस्टम में ओपीटी फोल्डर में लैंप फोल्डर के अंदर एचटी डॉक्स के अंदर जो हमने मॉडल फोल्डर कॉपी किया होगा उसके अंदर मिलेगी. दिस इज द पाथ इन दैट config.php फाइल इज देयर. So, यहाँ पे आपको चेंज करना है. और एक और चेंजेस आपको यहाँ पे मैंने दिखा देता हूं जो इंपॉर्टेंट है. सी यहाँ पे आपको ये फाइल मिलेगी, यू कैन क्लिक एंड ओपन दिस फाइल.
एक्सक्यूज मी मॉलिक सर, आई थिंक मेनी ऑफ द पार्टिसिपेंट कैन नॉट सी योर स्क्रीन. देयर आर मेनी पीपल सेइंग दैट दे कैन नॉट सी यू.
Actually, they not selecting my presentation block, so that's the reason.
Sir, I would suggest, why don't you just unpresent yourself and again present yourself?
Okay.
That
okay,
may no issue. Make a difference.
Yeah, it also there. Jatin sir, now it's visible?
Yes, it is coming. Yes, it is coming now.
Yeah.
You can go to the other screen. That's it. It is visible now.
Yeah. So, यहाँ से हम अपना local host के बजे आपका live IP enter करेंगे. So, live IP से ये outside of the campus or university में भी ये आपको Moodle का access मिल जाएगा. Now, मैं quickly विंडोज में कैसे इंस्टॉल करते हैं वो आपको बता देता हूं. आपके पास अगर मोस्टली लिनक्स सर्वर नहीं होगा, विंडोज सर्वर ही होगा. सो विंडोज सर्वर में कैसे करेंगे, फर्स्ट आपको विंडोज सर्वर में ज़ैम्प इंस्टॉल करना होगा. सी दिस द आइकॉन ऑफ द ज़ैम्प. आई विल गिव यू द लिंक टू इंस्टॉल द ज़ैम्प. इट इज इजी, क्लिक नेक्स्ट 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 एंड इंस्टॉल. इट इज डैम इजी टू इंस्टॉल ज़ैम्प. सो यू कैन click on this XAMPP server. You can start from here, Apache server and MySQL server. ये मैं विंडोज में बता रहा हूं कि विंडोज सर्वर में क्यों, विंडोज 7, 8, 10 जो भी यूज करते हैं कैसे होगा. मैंने स्टार्ट कर दिया है. यहां से मैंने अपनी लोकल होस्ट में लिखूंगा, सो यहां से मुझे XAMPP मिलेगा. यहाँ से मैं मॉडल इंस्टॉल करूंगा, सेम प्रोसीजर मैंने प्रीवियसली फॉलो की थी, सेम प्रोसीजर यहाँ पे भी फॉलो करनी है। सी डेटाबेस डी मॉडल, सी द डेटाबेस टेबल्स, यू कैन टेक ए बैकअप फ्रॉम एक्सपोर्ट। नाउ मैं आपको बता देता हूँ कि ये इंस्टॉलेशन के बाद कैसे स्ट्रक्चराइज होगा। ये मैंने क्या किया कि मेरा एक लाइव आईपी है मेरे इंस्टीट्यूट का, ये इंस्टीट्यूट लाइव आईपी में मैंने अपना मॉडल सेटअप किया है। अगर आप अपने लोकल मशीन में इंस्टॉल करेंगे तो यहाँ पे आपको क्या लिखना होगा, सिर्फ ये लिखना होगा लोकल होस्ट 10 मॉडल। सो डायरेक्टली ये लोकल होस्ट मॉडल से आपके सिस्टम में आ जाएगा। मैंने लाइव आईपी सेट किया है सो मुझे ये आ रहा है। यहाँ पे मैं लॉगिन करता हूँ एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव साइट, मींस वो जो मैंने सुपर यूजर बनाया था एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव का, वो मैं यहाँ पे इनपुट कर रहा हूँ। तो यहाँ से मुझे एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव के राइट मिलेंगे। सी दिस इज द फ्रंट पेज सेटिंग जो हमने सेट किए थे, फ्रंट पेज सेटिंग सेट किए थे। मैं इसको टर्न एडिटिंग ऑन कर देता हूँ, फ्रंट पेज सेटिंग। यहाँ से मैं क्या कर सकता हूँ, यहाँ से मैं पूरा मॉडल का फ्रंट पेज सेटअप कर सकता हूँ। सो मैं आपको बताने चला हूँ कि तीन चीज इंपॉर्टेंट है, कैटेगरी, कोर्स एंड देयर, उसमें अगर आपको फीस डालना हो तो, विच विल डिटेल स्टडी इन लेटर ऑन डेज। बेसिकली मैं आपको जस्ट कहाँ से आता है वो आपको एक बार बता देता हूँ। सी इज अ साइट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, यहाँ से कोर्स ऑप्शन है, मैनेज कोर्स एंड कैटेगरी। मैंने क्या किया है कि मैंने ईयर वाइज अपने इंस्टीट्यूट में कोर्स पहले कैटेगरी क्रिएट कर ली, यहाँ से मैंने कैटेगरी क्रिएट कर ली है। सो क्रिएट कैटेगरी, यहाँ से मैंने कैटेगरी क्रिएट कर ली है ईयर 2014 एंड 15। देन सब कैटेगरी सेमेस्टर 1, सेमेस्टर 2, सेमेस्टर 3, 4, 5 लाइक वाइज। आपके इंस्टीट्यूट में अगर जो भी आप कैटेगरी डालना चाहते हो आप कैटेगरी डाल सकते हो, लाइक फर्स्ट ईयर, सेकेंड ईयर, थर्ड ईयर लाइक वाइज। सो इस कैटेगरी के अंदर मैं सब्जेक्ट इनपुट करूंगा। सी आई एम क्लिकिंग ऑन सब कैटेगरी सेमेस्टर 1, इन दैट आई एम क्रिएटिंग ए न्यू कोर्स। सो आई एम क्रिएटिंग ए कोर्स एंड विथ देयर कोड, दीज आर द डिफरेंट कोर्सेस। सो मैंने क्या किया कि फर्स्ट मैंने क्रिएट कैटेगरी क्रिएट की है, उसके अंदर सब कैटेगरी सेमेस्टर 1 क्रिएट की है, उसके अंदर ऑल कोर्स इनपुट कर दिए है। अगर अब मैं क्या करूंगा, अब मैं ये करूंगा कि यहाँ पे मैं कोर्स में यूजर को एनरोल करूंगा। यूजर को एनरोल करने के लिए आपको दो टाइप के रोल देने होंगे जो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर दे सकता है रोल, के जो स्टूडेंट है वो क्या कर सकता है, वो सिर्फ व्यू कर सकता है, वो कोर्स को एडिट नहीं कर सकता, वो कोर्स क्रिएट नहीं कर सकता, वो कोई कैटेगरी और सब कैटेगरी क्रिएट नहीं कर सकता, वो जस्ट व्यू कर सकता है और जो लर्न कर सकता है। टीचर क्या कर सकता है, वो अपने ही कोर्स का ही, सिर्फ फॉर एग्जांपल ये इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक करके एक कोर्स है तो इस कोर्स का ही वो मैनेज कर सकता है, उसमें क्विज कर सकता है, उसमें असाइनमेंट डाल सकता है, उसमें जो भी एक्टिविटी है वो रिसोर्स है वो इसमें वो टीचर अपने ही कोर्स में कर सकता है, दूसरे के कोर्स में नहीं कर सकता। और एक अलग कैटेगरी, एक अलग रोल है जो मैनेजर का रोल होता है, वो मैनेज करता है ऑल दिस कोर्स, लाइक अवर कोर्स काउंसलर, अवर डिपार्टमेंट काउंसलर लाइक वाइज। सी सो ये सब यहाँ पे भी दिया गया है। यूजर का मैंने आपको एक बार बता देता हूँ कि यूजर का कैसे होता है कोर्स में से, जो मैंने आपको बताया था यूजर का लिस्ट कैसे ब्राउज करते हैं, बल्क एक्शन कैसे करते हैं, एक साथ अपलोड यूजर करना हो तो कैसे करेंगे। सी मैं एक कोर्स क्रिएट करके दिखाता हूं आपको कि कोर्स कैसे होता है। मैंने यहाँ पे अपना एक कोर्स इनपुट कर दिया है फर्स्ट ईयर का. सी दीज आर द हाइड. सी मैं लॉग आउट हो जाता हूं, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर से लॉगिन करता हूं सिंपल टीचर यूजर में. आप टीचर हो तो आप टीचर यूजर, ये मेरा आईडी है, मैं यहां से लॉगिन करता हूं तो मुझे क्या मिलेगा, टीचर का ही रोल मिलेगा. यहां से मैं टीचर्स के रोल से मैं अपना कोर्स क्रिएट कर सकता हूं. यहां पे मैंने एक कोर्स क्रिएट किया गया है माय कोर्स. सी यहां पे मेरा कोर्स है, एक प्लेसमेंट कैटेगरी और उसका एक कोर्स है, और एक कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क सब्जेक्ट है उसका एक कोर्स दिया गया है. सो यहां पे मैंने ये दो कोर्स ही मुझको मिलेंगे. अगर मैं कोई अलग टीचर है, मींस के कोई अलग सब्जेक्ट है, लाइक ये टेक्निकल सब्जेक्ट है, अगर मुझको कोई कैरियर डेवलपमेंट का एक अलग से कोर्स डिफाइन करना हो, तो मैंने एक अलग से कोर्स डिफाइन किया है कि कैरियर डेवलपमेंट, उसके अंदर मुझे कंटेंट डालना है, तो सपोज तो मुझे एक अलग से रोल देना होगा टीचर को. यहाँ पे फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं एक अलग से एक रोल दे देता हूं. मैं एक अलग टीचर के रोल से एंटर करता हूं तो उसको भी मुझको यहाँ पे सेम ऐसा मिलेगा फ्रंट पेज. सी नाउ मैं आपको ये एक इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग देता देता हूं कि यहाँ पे मैंने कोर्स कैटेगरी की है फर्स्ट ईयर डिग्री इंजीनियरिंग किया है. यहाँ से मैं स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स क्या करेंगे, स्टूडेंट्स यहाँ से लॉग इन करेंगे, स्टूडेंट्स का लॉग इन सब वगैरह यहाँ से होगा, राइट. Now important part which I cover in presentation, just a second. See, as I said, what is the course? The course is basic learning area in which Moodle, where teacher display the material for their students. यहाँ पे ये मैं आपको PPT शेयर कर दूंगा after the end of the session. Category. A category is a group of things, has several meaning of Moodle. It can be group of course, as I displayed. Then activity. In that you can input dozen of activity tools in a course. You can put quiz, you can put survey, you can take a feedback from the students, as well as you can give the assignment to the students, you can share materials. What is block? The block are the item which may added left or right side of course homepage. So you can add a calendar, as well as you can enter a forum block, you can enter a recent activity block, you can enter a message or chat box block. See, this is important plugin. So plugin kya hai, agar Moodle administrator hai jo usko Moodle mein aur functionality chahiye jo Moodle ke origin website mein plugin diye gaye hai, like अगर आपने कोई क्वीज डाली है स्टूडेंट्स के लिए कि भाई 100 क्वेश्चन है, एक घंटे में 100 क्वेश्चन कंप्लीट करने हैं, और स्टूडेंट्स ने 100 क्वेश्चन कंप्लीट कर दिए, ऐसे पांच कोर्स है, सब्जेक्ट वन, सब्जेक्ट टू, सब्जेक्ट थ्री, सब्जेक्ट फोर एंड सब्जेक्ट फाइव. तो 100 स्टूडेंट्स, फाइव सब्जेक्ट, हाउ मच बर्डन बर्डन आएगा टीचर पे, कितना बर्डन आएगा कि भाई पांच सब्जेक्ट के 100 स्टूडेंट्स के क्वेश्चन चेक करने हैं. अगर आपने एमसीक्यू दिए गए हैं चार ऑप्शन में से एक, तो वो तो कोई इजी है, क्योंकि क्या है कि भाई ट्रू ऑप्शन आएगा तो 100% मार्क्स मिलेंगे, वहीं पे रिजल्ट मिल जाएगा. अगर स्टूडेंट्स को आपको ऐसा देना है कि भाई कोई शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन का आंसर लिखना है, अगर कोई पैराग्राफ लिखना है, तो उस केस में क्या होगा, आपको इंडिविजुअली एक एक क्वेश्चन ईच स्टूडेंट्स के देखने होंगे. सो विच इज वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड विच इज वेरी लेंथी प्रोसेस. So for that, some of plugins are available, which are installed through this just a second. Yeah. You can install plugin from here. Install plugin. So I have installed few of plugin. See, reports plugin, manage report. Report के लिए मैंने plugin install किए हैं कहीं कि जो मुझे स्टूडेंट्स को ग्रेड हिस्ट्री अगर अगर स्टूडेंट्स ने फाइव सब्जेक्ट्स की क्विज अटेम्प्ट की है तो उसको फाइव सब्जेक्ट्स के ग्रेड उसका रिपोर्ट कैसे जनरेट करना है उसका परसेंटेज कैसे आता है सभी डिटेल्स को मुझको थरोली उसको पूरा मार्कशीट जैसा कुछ बना के देना है रिपोर्ट ग्रेड शीट बना के देनी है तो मुझे अलग से कोई प्लग इन इंस्टॉल करना पड़ेगा. मॉडल में ऑप्शन दिए गए हैं लेकिन वो बेसिक ऑप्शन है. यहाँ से आप प्लगइन आप देख सकते हो कि प्लगइन कौन से इंस्टॉल करने हैं. फ्रंट पेज का भी ऑप्शन दिया गया है. रिपोर्ट ऑप्शन यहाँ से पूरा रिपोर्ट मिलेगा आपको. ये एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव के लिए है टीचर्स के लिए नहीं है. टीचर्स के लिए तो कोर्स कैटेगरी क्विज एक्टिविटी वगैरह है ये एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव के लिए ही है ओनली. Now almost are covered from administrative side. Basically almost are covered. I just check if anything. Yeah, as I explained the role, the teacher role, student role, as well as the manager role. Yeah, almost are completed from administrative side. हाँ मैं एक बार ये बता दूं अगर कोई मैक यूजर है तो मैक यूजर को क्या करना होगा. मैक यूजर को अलग से इंस्टॉल करना होगा. मैक यूजर मैं वो भी आपको एक बार दिखा देता हूं. मैक यूजर को कैसे करना होगा. मैक यूजर को ये एक सॉफ्टवेयर है मॉडल फॉर मैक करके वो उसकी इमेज फाइल होगी ये डीएमजी फाइल है उसको डाउनलोड करना होगा. लिंक मैं आपको रिसोर्स में दे दूंगा. ये आपको इंस्टॉल करना होगा. इट विल टेक ए टाइम फॉर इंस्टॉलिंग. Drag these two application folder and it will start the installation. No need to installation the all previous stuffs. But Mac में कोई rarely install करता है users के लिए. Generally Windows server और Linux server ज्यादा use करते हैं. Yeah, it will take less than a minute, so let's see. हेलो हाँ जस्ट अ सेकंड. हाँ हेलो यहाँ पे मुड मैक में थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा इंस्टॉलेशन में, क्योंकि ये 2-4 मिनट का में नहीं होगा। सो मैं क्या करता हूँ कि आपको पूरा स्टेप्स दिखा देता हूँ कि पहले से आपको क्या करना है। नोट्स एक नोट्स क्रिएट करता हूँ, वहां से आपको पूरा ये दिखा देता हूँ कि कैसे पूरा होगा। टेक्स्ट फाइल, जस्ट अ सेकंड।
सर यू विल नीड अगेन टू शेयर द स्क्रीन।
या मैं पूरा एक वर्ड फाइल में पूरा स्टेप्स लिखा दिखा देता हूँ कि कैसे करना है। एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव साइड क्या करना है और टीचर के साइड क्या करना है। जतिन सर इज विजिबल वर्ड डॉक्यूमेंट?
यस सर इट इज विजिबल एंड देयर इज वन क्वेश्चन बाय मिस्टर सोपान। Sir, in the beginning you told about system requirements, i5 processor, 100 GB hard disk and 8 GB RAM. So if one doesn't have these things, this software can't work. Please reply.
Yeah, so yeah, it can work, but you need to minimum 15 students. Suppose aapke paas 15 students hai, 15 se 100 ke beech mein. So it minimum requirement. Agar aap 10 se 15 students ke beech mein karna chahte hai, to aapke paas i3 ho to bhi chalega. 4 GB RAM i3 हो तो भी चलेगा। I talk about the more students, then we need a minimum requirement. Clear?
Yes. We can actually use it on less RAM also and less hard disk drive also. But the thing is, why sir is focusing on this is because जो उनका एक्सपीरियंस रहा है उनके कॉलेज में कि उनको एक साथ 200-300 बच्चों का एग्जाम लेना होता है। सो फॉर दैट ऑल दोस पर्पस दीज रिक्वायरमेंट्स आर बेटर एंड दीज रिक्वायरमेंट्स दे हैव आल्सो यूज्ड आई थिंक यू पीपल हैव यूज्ड फॉर एंड्रॉइड प्रोग्रामिंग एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स राइट।
या
सो दीज रिक्वायरमेंट्स आर सेम फॉर इफ यू वांट टू डू एंड्रॉइड प्रोग्रामिंग आल्सो एंड मैनेज दिस काइंड ऑफ सर्वर आल्सो। सो दिस काइंड ऑफ सर्वर विल once 300 people at a time connect then 8 GB RAM will be sufficient for that. We have also faced many a times issue in our institute when we try to use it locally. If we try to install a local server and try to take an exam of more than 200 or 300 people, then many of them are not able to connect just because of this problem. So there are many things that need to be taken care of, or hardware part also. If you want to attend a attend a larger cloud or cover a larger crowd in your Moodle.
It required because simultaneously 300 students hit at a time it's maximum possibility to crash your Moodle server.
Yes, and Dipti ma'am is asking, isn't it more suitable for larger servers like college? Yes, ma'am. Actually, installation part has to be done on a live server or on an internet server which is having good capacity. You can even do it on your own laptop also. That is not a big issue. If it has just 2 GB RAM and not much hard disk space, then also that is not an issue. But it will only face issue when the people start connecting to it. When your students start connecting to it, it will not be able to support more number of connections. So that's why a server configuration is required. And Sachin sir is asking, how can it work during lockdown? Can something which will work on mobile? Okay. Sir, I would like to answer that.
Can I give the answer? एक्चुअली आप अपने लैपटॉप में, हाँ अगर आप अपने लैपटॉप में और कोई पीसी में अगर ये आपने इंस्टॉल कर दिया है और आपको स्टूडेंट्स को ये एक्सेस करने देना है, तो क्या है कि मोबाइल में भी मूडल की एक ऐप आती है, उसमें अगर ये एंड्रॉइड में भी है और आईफोन में भी है, ये ऐप इंस्टॉल स्टूडेंट्स करेंगे, उसमें आपको सिर्फ URL ही प्रोवाइड करनी है। जो ये URL आप ब्राउजर में ओपन कर रहे हो, वो URL आपको स्टूडेंट्स को देनी है। वो URL वो स्टूडेंट्स उस मोबाइल ऐप में इंस्टॉल करे टाइप करेगा और फर्स्ट टाइम ही उसको पूछेगा कि भाई कौन सी URL से आप मूडल एक्सेस करना चाहते हैं, फिर वो आपका जो मूडल सेटअप किया है वो एप्लीकेशन के थ्रू वो एक्सेस कर सकता है। Yeah, Jatin sir.
Yes, that's right. And during lockdown ke liye mein, I would suggest ke for that you need to have that server running in your college with a live IP. So live IP pe hai agar aapka server, so you will be easily able to access it. As you would have seen ke Maulik sir was accessing one of the Moodle on his one of his servers, which was yeah. live from their college.
Yeah, actually ये physical access नहीं कर सकते ना, इसका ही issue है कि मैंने एक video create किया है, वो video के base के आपको समझा रहा हूँ. अगर live होता तो उसकी वो एक different scenario होता.
Yes, so I think sir अभी आपने जो IP डाला था, that was your live Moodle server, right?
Yeah, my जो मैंने IP डाला था वो live है. Institutes में एक server है, वो चल रहा है, वहां से मैं एक्सेस कर रहा था वो.
यस, सो ही शोड यू हाउ टू एक्सेस इट, बट देर आर अदर ऑप्शंस आल्सो. इफ यू हैव दैट पीसी और दैट सर्वर लाइव कंट्रोल, दैट इज विंडोज के थ्रू आप अगर लाइव कंट्रोल उसको कर सकते हैं.
सिंपल सिंपल
यस, देन सिंपल एक्सेस कर सकते हैं, तो फिर रिमोटली भी आप ये सब कॉन्फिगर कर सकते हैं.
Definitely, definitely, definitely. Simple, कोई भी Windows PC में ये इंस्टॉल करके उसका, अगर आपके पास वो IP है लाइव IP, so वो लाइव IP बाइंड करके आप किसी को दे सकते हैं और किसी को एक्सेस करवा सकते हैं. आपके घर बैठे ही आपको आप करवा सकते हैं, अगर इंस्टीट्यूट का पीसी वगैरह कोई यूज करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है.
ओके, उषा मैम इज आस्किंग विदाउट कॉलेज कोलैबोरेशन वी कैन नॉट रन दिस प्रोग्राम. नो मैम, इट्स नॉट दैट. You can run this. We will be using gnomio.com only. Gnomio.com yeah. is a live Moodle cloud based provider, and it provides us whole site. So what all things sir did right now, the installation part, that installation part is totally skipped. You don't need it only. And
it's for the administrative. It's for the network administrative.
Yes, yes.
Totally
yes.
for the network administrative. Yes. Teacher yes, part so will be covered by teacher part will be covered later on, because you are at your home and you cannot access your physical server at your college. So we will set up all in Gnomio, which are the internet based, so you can access at your home, and Jatin sir will explain all the thing in how to access through Gnomio, which is cloud Moodle.
Yes
yeah.
I hope that is I'm clear with.
I just write right? down the step for the network administrator. ब्राउजर में आप लिखेंगे लोकल होस्ट मॉडल और इंस्टॉलेशन प्रोसेस स्टार्ट हो जाएगी, जो मैंने वीडियो में एक्सप्लेन की है पूरी इंस्टॉलेशन डेटाबेस सेटअप्स वगैरह. आपको यहाँ पे डेटाबेस नेम इनपुट करना है सिंपल, और अगर कोई क्वेरी आए तो वो वहां पे मैंने जो आपको दो तीन क्वेरी आई थी जो वो अपडेट्स करनी है. अगर आप MariaDB यूज करते हैं तो, MySQL यूज करते हैं तो कोई क्वेरी नहीं आएगी. और सेकंड थिंग, जो आपने एक बार इंस्टॉलेशन कर लिया, फिर यूजर का सेटअप करना है, वो भी मैंने वीडियो में दिखा दिया है कि भाई यूजर का सेटअप कैसे करते हैं. इसके बाद ये कंप्लीट होने के बाद आपको फ्रंट पेज का सेटअप आएगा, जो मैंने वीडियो में एक्सप्लेन किया है. फ्रंट पेज साइट्स का सेटअप क्रिएट करना है। बस सिंपल यही स्टेप्स है। यहाँ इस स्टेप से आपको वो मॉडल फिजिकली मॉडल इंस्टॉल हो जाएगा, इसमें कोई इश्यू नहीं रहेगा, लेकिन इट विल टेक ए टाइम, राइट।
ओके, सो दीज आर द वेरी सिंपल स्टेप्स दैट एनीवन कैन फॉलो फॉर इंस्टॉलेशन। आई वुड सजेस्ट इफ यू वांट टू हैव अ हैंड्स ऑन विद द टेक्निकलिटीज ऑफ दिस, then you should go ahead with this. Out of these three steps that sir has mentioned, you can just install XAMPP server on Windows. I hope most of you will be using Windows only. So just install, download a XAMPP server, latest XAMPP server, and install it on your PC or laptop. And once you install it, there will be a folder which sir has mentioned, that is LAMP HT docs. In LAMP folder, there will be HT docs. HT docs folder, inside that HT docs folder only, you can directly put your the Moodle's zip file that you have
downloaded.
Sujata ma'am is asking, as folder, sir told, there are certain requirements.
HT docs, XAMPP folder है, XAMPP folder में HT docs, यहाँ पे मुझे पेस्ट करना है Moodle का जो zip file मैंने जो डाउनलोड किया है वो, फिर सिंपल लोकल होस्ट स्लैश Moodle, that's all, then process will start automatically.
Okay, so afterwards it is next, you have to go ahead with next, clicking on next, and you can refer the video that sir has given. Okay, so Sujata ma'am is asking, as sir told, there are certain requirements which are to be met to download by teachers, so in same way students have to also meet software requirements. No, ma'am. There are no specific software requirements. Since this is a portal, so you can access it by browser. So you can access it by the URL which students can enter in the address bar.
Only good updated browser.
Yes. So it's nowadays normally people use Chrome and Mozilla. So, and some people even use Internet Explorer. So it's better to go with Mozilla and Chrome. In that, the view will be proper, and that's it. They can even access it from the browser of mobile. If they enter the live IP or they enter the IP address of the particular server on which the Moodle has been hosted, they will be able to access it. Yes, Dipti ma'am is asking, so for this FTP, are we expected to create our own Moodle site or the entire course will be on Gnomeo? Okay, ma'am, I will just come to this question later on, because that is what I'm going to explain. So thank you for asking that. I'll surely come on to your question once Maulik sir finishes, because that's what the main target I am going to cover today. Okay,
yeah, those who are administrator, they can ask how to do, is there any query for the network side. Teacher side will be covered by Jatin sir, how to use in Gnomeo. Anyone?
Swati ma'am is asking, sir, is it possible we do this hands-on practice of installation along with you side by side? Ma'am, for that only Maulik sir has put the video. In our gnomeo.com Moodle, where I will show you how to access it also. And what I would suggest is you open that video in YouTube, keep it in a half part of your screen. And then in the other half part of your screen, you start doing the processes, whatever is shown in that, right? And this installation part, that if you want to skip, then you don't worry, you will be able to do it the same with gnomeo.com, and that I will show you within some time how to do that on gnomeo.com, so that installations part will be totally skipped in that.
Yeah, and Jatin sir, I will mostly the user are the Windows using Windows platform, right? So I think I need to create one Windows installation video. It's a 4 to 5 minutes video. I will create it and share on the resource.
And that installation part, Swati madam, right now, if sir will do that, then our whole this thing will go ahead, because in sometimes what happens is it takes about 1 to 1.5 hour time also for installation. And normally, if your PC is good, the system requirements that sir was mentioning, if that system requirements are there, then it will get finished within half an hour. It won't take much time.
Yeah, yeah. And one more thing, ये जो आप पूरा स्क्रीन जो प्रेजेंट हो रहा है वो आप प्लीज लैपटॉप और डेस्कटॉप स्क्रीन में देखें तो आपको प्रॉपर पता चल जाएगा. मोबाइल स्क्रीन इट जस्ट फॉर द हियरिंग वॉइस एंड ऑल. अगर आप लैपटॉप यूज करेंगे तो आपको प्रॉपरली फर्दर डेज में आपको पता चलेगा, क्योंकि मोबाइल स्क्रीन में इतना आपको नहीं प्रॉपरली पता चलेगा. राइट जतिन सर?
Yes, it would be better you go side by side. That is called side by side method. IIT Bombay also, Spoken Tutorials, they also focus on this method itself, that is side by side method. When we went there, we had to do the same method, and I also made my students learn using the same method in many subjects. That is very best method, side by side method, where video is going on left side and you can do your operations on right side. Okay, so Dr. Zarin Setna is saying, unfortunately, some of us do not have access to laptop right now. Don't worry, sir. You will be able to at least take part as a participant in the Moodle. And taking part as a participant in a Moodle itself will give you a different feel, because that feel of being a student in an LMS, that itself is worthy of to have for some time. So you will have to be a student in our gnomeo.com site, and you will have to go through all the activities which are present on that. Okay. So Malik sir, anything from your side now?
Yeah, clear that. Completing.
Okay, sir. So I'll do one thing now. I'll start presenting. Okay, so are you people now able to see my screen? I think yes, it is going on. It has started also. Yes. So let me. Okay. So let me show you. Let me take you to the gnomeo.com site. This site is, this is the address. If you are having laptop right now and you have not made any site on gnomeo.com, then I would suggest you go to this site, that is www.gnomio.com, and in this site you will get this site type of template, and here directly you will get this you can say structure where you will have to fill the details. So yahan se aap apni site create kar sakte hain. You can see what they have provided. They have provided that, they have said that create your site or URL daliye. URL means the main address of your site. So it's uniform resource locator. So yahan pe suppose I put jatincet.gnomeo.com. See, all sites that you create on Gnomeo, all Moodle sites will have the extension as .gnomio.com, that is .gnomeo.com. And before that dot, योर नेम विल अपियर वॉट एवर यू पुट, जो आपको रखना है आप रख सकते हैं. द ओनली थिंग इज इट शुड बी अवेलेबल ऑन देयर साइड. सो इफ समवन हैज नॉट केप्ट दिस एड्रेस देन इट विल बी अवेलेबल एंड देन यू कैन गिव योर ईमेल ओवर हियर. यहाँ से आप इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज सेलेक्ट करें विच इज डिफॉल्ट. यू सेलेक्ट दिस एंड यू क्रिएट द साइट. सो आई विल राइट नाउ नॉट मेक दिस क्रिएट साइट बिकॉज आई हैव ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड बिफोर सम टाइम. सो वॉट हैपन्स इज वेन यू क्रिएट द साइट इट विल टेक फॉर अबाउट 2 to 3 minutes. ओके, 2 to 3 minutes लगेंगे इसको एंड इट मे टेक अबाउट 4 to 5 minutes डिपेंडिंग ऑन द ट्राफिक. And what it will do is it will send you a mail. This is my account, mail account, jatin.cet2@gmail.com. I made it temporarily. And you can see there is a welcome mail. So I have not yet opened it. I had just created this site before some time only. So you can see. Now, see what they have provided. They have provided that this is your Moodle site is ready. This is the address. Okay. And this is the username and this is the password. So I'll just copy the password. I'll click on it. And you can see here, using this address, the site will open up. So you can see a basic structure has become ready. The installation part is totally skipped. You have skipped the installation part. You don't need to what is the server, what is the server size, what is the RAM size, ye sab cheeze aapko dekhne ki zarurat nahi padti. Directly within 10 minutes you get ready for going online with your courses. So you can see the site name is there, welcome to Moodle. Ye jo ye sara message hai, this message will appear on everybody's site. And below this, all your content will be visible. Right now, I have not created anything. This is a fresh site. So since this is a fresh site, इसमें आपको कुछ नहीं मिल रहा. So I will just log in. यहाँ से मैं log in कर सकता हूँ. And I will have to put my email address, jatin.cet2@ sorry, actually not my even address. Even they have given the username and password. So I'll just copy this password. Yahan pe main likhunga admin and here the password. So username aur password maine copy kar liya kisme se, mail mein se, jo mail nomia.com ne mujhe bheja tha. Kab bheja ye mail? When I requested them to make this kind of website for me. And jaise hi ye ban jati hai, they will mail you. So using this login credentials, I am now logging in to jatincet2.gnomeo.com. So now you can see they have provided me with a very basic template. This is the Moodle site. This is the navigation bar. If you click this, if you click this part, it will open and close. And this is your main menu, from where you can go to dashboard, or you can log out, you can even make your preferences, you can set your profile. So this is the first thing that you have to do, setting up the profile. But I will not show you right now over here. I will show it to you on the Moodle that we have to use, that is you have to use as a student. Okay. And these are the messages. If you have got any messages or any notifications are there, right? So as an admin user, you have logged in. Okay. Then there are courses. Okay. Malik sir, I would suggest if there are any, comments, then would you please tell me, because I will not be able to see my screen.
Okay. Some of asking that Yahoo mail address. Yes, Zarin
sir, you can use any email address, not Gmail, but you can use any email address. to log in to this particular vinomia.com. And other question is, sorry if my question sounds silly, but if it's possible to create our site so easily, why do we need to install it? Yes, Zarin sir, the installation part is necessary Zarin, because
sir. Yes Zarin, sir, please go ahead. Yeah, Dr. Zarin is a madam, so
okay, sorry for that. Yes ma'am, the thing is, then why do we need to install it is a very basic question. If you consider that you want your data to be secure, then you need to consider this part. So many institutions who have got people who are very good at networking and server maintenance side, what they do is they prefer to have their own site at their own location with a live IP. Normally, most institutions, most engineering institutions today have about at least 3 to 4 live IP available with them. At least one is there. So on that live IP, the first reason is the speed in the internet is much faster. So if students are accessing the if they are accessing the Moodle from the college itself, then the speed will be very different from that is which is available on internet. Second thing, all the data stays with, yes sir, please go ahead.
Yeah, can I give the explanation, simple explanation of this question?
Yes sir, please go ahead, because you have got a very much experience in that. And would just mention Zarin ma'am that Maulik sir has been using this Moodle in their institution since many years, and they are preferring their own live IP only. They also yes please go ahead sir.
या एक्चुअली क्या है कि अगर आप आपके पास लार्ज मास है स्टूडेंट्स का और आपको अपने इंस्टीट्यूट में से ही लोकल नेटवर्क में से ही यूज करना है तो आपको क्या प्रिफर करना पड़ेगा फिजिकल कोई सर्वर में इंस्टॉल करना मोस्ट रिकमेंडेड रहेगा क्योंकि क्या है कि आपको अपने कैंपस में ही यूज करना है अगर आपको घर बैठे कोई स्टूडेंट्स को आपको देना है तो क्या है तो फिजिकल सर्वर में लाइव आईपी सेट करके आप दे सकते हैं उसमें क्या है कि भाई इंटरनेट एक्सेस मिल सकता है इंटरनेट एक्सेस के थ्रू ही होगा बट ये लैन के लिए मोस्ट रिकमेंडेड है आपके कैंपस और यूनिवर्सिटी में पूरा ये फिजिकली मोस्ट रिकमेंडेड रहेगा क्लियर और ये एक दूसरा एक बात अगर आप अपनी वेबसाइट होस्ट करना चाहते हैं तो आपको क्या करना होगा भाई गोडेडी में जाना पड़ेगा और बिग रॉक में जाना पड़ेगा आपको होस्टिंग का स्पेस लेना पड़ेगा डोमेन लेना पड़ेगा वहां पे आप अपनी वेबसाइट आप बना सकते हैं ये क्या है कि ये एक वेबसाइट ही है लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट वेबसाइट उसके लिए आपको खुद ही सर्वर इंस्टॉल करना पड़ेगा और ये वेबसाइट आपको खुद ही कॉन्फ़िगर करनी पड़ेगी वो अपने ही कैंपस में सो स्टूडेंट कैन एक्सेस दिस लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट प्लेटफॉर्म योर ऑन कैंपस एंड मैं जो हार्डवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट्स की बात कर रहा हूँ वो क्या है कि वो जो है हार्डवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट वो ज्यादा स्टूडेंट्स होंगे अगर एक साथ आप 100+ स्टूडेंट्स को एक साथ एक्सेस करवाना चाहते हो तो ही ये हार्डवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट्स नेसेसरी है अदरवाइज मिनिमल हार्डवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट्स इज रिकमेंडेड इट यूज i3 प्रोसेसर हो तो भी चलेगा कोई इश्यू नहीं है 4GB रैम है तो भी चलेगा कोई इश्यू नहीं है मिनिमम 40GB हार्ड डिस्क है तो भी चलेगा कोई इश्यू नहीं है लेकिन एट ए टाइम आपको मोर देन स्टूडेंट 100+ स्टूडेंट्स को एक्सेस करवाना है देन एंड देन यू गो फॉर दिस हार्डवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट्स जतिन सर
यस सर एंड थैंक्स रंजन सर रंजन सर इज राइट इफ यू इंस्टॉल इट देन यू हैव द फैसिलिटी ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा पार्टिसिपेंट्स पर कोर्स सो सपोज लेट्स सपोज दैट यू आर यूजिंग मूडल एंड देयर आर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ यूजर्स and with years going on, the number of students increase, and obviously there is the data of older students that we have to keep, right? That we cannot delete it. So that facility is available with you, that you can increase the number of participants, the number of connections. You can even add your own plugins that you want, right? And also saves the cloud storage cost. That is right, Ranjan sir. and the security part has to be taken care of. That is critical. There needs to be a proper security network engineer or security engineer on the institution side who has to take care of that. And yes, there is one more question Dipti ma'am is asking. Can you explain the difference between LMS like Moodle and Google Classroom? Okay. Dipti ma'am, the LMS like Google Classroom we cannot say it's a full type of LMS, because it has focused merely on inculcating or incorporating all the Google facilities, that is like Docs, Slides, and Forms, and all those things into the classroom thing. So their main focus is that they have the four main things coming. That is this thing, the user, which is a Google user, a Gmail account, which is for communication, then the classroom where students and teachers are there who can communicate. So their main focus is on communication. They have taken into consideration most of the excepts, these things of LMS which are needed in LMS, but they are unable to provide many things which Moodle and other LMSs provide. For example, they are unable to provide the automation which Moodle provides. They are unable to provide different kinds of questions that Moodle or other LMSs provide. They provide about 10 to 14 types of 10 to 12 types of questions. Almost 12 types of questions are there in Google Classroom, whereas in Moodle there are more than 20 types of questions are there which you can try to give your users. And there are other facilities also, like gamification, which allows you to make more than 10 types of games. So that is one of the best part of Moodle, as if you compare it to Google Classroom. So we can also say that there can be an easy comparison between Moodle and Google Classroom, because Google Classroom is a different thing where you just start easily with it's very easy to start with Google Classroom if you have G Suite application. So yesterday I asked Mala ma'am whether you people provide the facility of giving institution based Gmail to your students. If that is the case in your institution, then you can easily go with Google Classroom. There is no issue in that. But then for that, you will have to also purchase the Google for Education, and then that will be per user basis also. So all those costs matter. And in Moodle's case, why we are preferring Gnomeo.com? Because Gnomeo.com is is made by a people who have gathered to share their expertise of Moodle, and they require only donation. They are not charging anything. There are other providers also, like Moodle Cloud is there, and many other sites are there which provide free Moodle hosting, like Gnomeo.com. But as compared to them, Gnomeo.com is providing lots of features. It is not even restricting you. I have myself taken about more than 300 people's exam at a time on Gnomeo.com, and it was very, very fast. There was not a single delay in that. So that are some of the advantages that we can have if we use such kind of sites like Gnomeo.com or your own paid hosting like Moodle Cloud, which and there are other two to three Moodle supporters, or we can say Moodle partners, which provide you with paid paid versions of Moodle, where you can settle for your n number of students. So for example, if you have 5,000 students, they will charge you something. If you have 10,000 students, they may charge you something for that, and that kind of facilities are available with them. But most of institutions focus on having their own Moodle, which is under their control. So that's why what they prefer is they prefer installing it on their own server and making it available live to all the people. Some even try to purchase these facilities from the Moodle partners, so they don't want to worry about the installation or the all the setup part. They just want to get started with the ready to use product, so they prefer using the Moodle partners. So they pay them, and the Moodle partners give them their specific site. They even design the site according to their needs, and then they deliver. So I hope you are clear with the question that I have answered. And now let's continue. I will take you to that site. You see, this was the message that I got when I put my when I created this jatincet2.economia.com. After that, I got the mail. In the mail, I got the link. It says it has been created. It gave me username, password. Once I logged into it, I am ready with a basic Moodle. Okay. So now that was about starting your own gnomio.com site. Very simple steps are there. You go to gnomio.com site. You put your credentials. That is, you put the name of the site that you want to keep, the URL. You give your email. You create site. It will send you the site related data in your email. Once the email arrives, you open it and you log in through the username password given, and you are ready to go with your own gnomio.com site. So this is one of the tasks that you people have to do, and you will also be doing various activities using this gnomio.com. So as I have made this jatincet.gnomio.com, and you may make, suppose for example, Dipti Majumdar, ma'am is there. So DiptiM.gnomio.com. Now it may happen that site name may not be available. If you try to use Dipti.gnomio.com, it may happen that name may not be available. So you may have to choose another name, right? So accordingly, you choose another name and you create your own site. So please note down that you people have this task in hand, okay? And that has to be taken care that you all of you make your own gnomio.com site, and and yes, so how many of you can cannot make the gnomio.com site using using laptop? Can you tell me just how many of you okay, so there are many questions. I'm sorry, I was not able to see the chat. Let me just see. Okay, Satyavan sir is asking, what about Canvas? Is Moodle better? Okay, Satyavan sir, the Canvas is we can say better version than Google Classroom, but Moodle is the best. We always if you ask any programmer or any system admin, then they will always prefer Moodle, because that is the best. You can configure it as per your needs. That is the best part. Canvas again is still, it is made by a proprietary people. It is available, open source is available, but there are various limitations in Canvas. Recently our experience was that when we are using Canvas in our own Marwadi University, and recently when there were some changes in the Canvas installation, so what they did is they made some changes in their services, and suddenly our Canvas broke, and for a month or so we were not able to properly set it up again, because there was this issue coming of compatibilities. So in that case, if you have Moodle, then you will not take more than a day's time to get ahead and get up back again and go online again. You just need a separate server, and as a system admin jo hote, they will have to obviously take the Moodle's backup regularly. So you may take the backup regularly, a monthly basis, on a weekly basis. So usi backup ko naye Moodle ke andar dal doge, so you will upload kar doge, so you will be able to get all your data ready. So that is the best part of Moodle. You can directly get started with it. Yes, Akarsha Samuel is asking, what about Canvas? Canvas has proctored system as well. Yes, Canvas and Moodle are there, that's right. Canvas has other facilities more than Moodle. So all these LMSs like Canvas, Blackboard, they try to put more facilities which are attractive to their users, to their customers. But if you ask for number of features, then the Moodle has the most number of features in, if you consider any LMS. IIT Bombay itself is using Moodle for its own courses since more than 10 years. If you would have participated in Fatak sir's any of the workshop, then you would have seen that there is a special Moodle that Fatak sir manages for his own classes, and there is a special Moodle of IITB also. And yes, Canvas and Moodle are, there are many comparable things, but we'll not go deep into that right now. Happy Mom is saying, as with the help of WordPress, we can create a website, but it has extension like xyz.wordpress.com. But if you pay it, it removes. Yes, that's right. That is also same with gnomeo.com. You have to pay. Gnomeo.com has one more thing. It will give you advertisements. So whenever you open the gnomeo.com site, there will be advertisements literally coming on. So this is one kind of advertisement you can see. I'll just present my screen. Okay, now I hope all of you are able to see my screen, right? Are you able to see my screen? I will do one thing. I'll switch off my
video. Yeah, sir, it's visible.
Okay, I will just switch off my video so that the bandwidth does not get. Okay, so in this, you can see this is the pharmasar.nomio.com site, where this first thing, welcome to your Moodle site. This itself is the web advertisement by the gnomeo.com and Moodle. Then your courses come. Okay, see, this is again an advertisement, free non-profit certificate, you see. So this is the only backdrop of gnomeo.com, that it gives lots of advertisements. Even your students will be able to see. And if you are sharing that gnomeo.com while you are teaching, you are using this gnomeo.com and showing something on it, then those advertisements will be visible to your students also. So that is one of the disadvantages. Yes, thank you, Malik sir. WordPress is not a learning management platform. That's right. It is just for making sites. Okay. Yes, Swati ma'am has created the account on PharmaSar. That's right, Swati ma'am. Okay, most of the you are saying yes. Nobody has said no, that, right? I told you to type that, whether any one of you are not able to use the laptop for making the site. Okay. Mokshita ma'am is saying they have made, she has made. Happy ma'am says said. All, most of them are saying yes. Okay, isn't it? No, Ramesh sir, nothing can block this advertisements. And the problem with this advertisements in gnomeo.com site is that if the user is using ad blocker in his browser, then he or she will not be able to even access that gnomeo.com site. So that is one of the problem. But we can ignore that thing, because there is not a difficult situation with all that comes to some only. Okay. Okay. Most of you have created the account. I'll just still show you how to create the account in this. So this is the pharmasar.nomio.com site. This is the Moodle you people will be accessing as participants, as students, and you will have to log into this particular course. The course is FDP on Moodle LMS for Patkar Varde College, Mumbai. There are other courses also, FDP in ICT and online FDP on transition to blended learning, teaching and learning. These FDPs have been already been completed by Ranjan sir and team. And this is the FDP in which you have to log in. So there is this option of self-enrollment. If I take my mouse on this, you can see this is showing self-enrollment. So you can go from here also, you can even click over here also, right? So let's go to the self-enrollment part. Okay. So now, as I went to pharmasar.nomio.com, okay, it is asking me to either log in, this is a login part, or to create a new account. So since I will have to create a new account, most of you will have to might not have created, so you will have to create a new account from here. Although Ranjan sir has shared that video, I am again showing this thing, so it becomes very easy for you to log into only specifically this pharmasar.nomio.com site. By mistake, do not log into any other site other than this. It may happen that you may create your account on any other nomio.com site, but don't do it. Make your login into pharmasar.nomio.com site. Yes sir, please.
Jatin sir, yes? Stop karin, fari paachu start kar diyo ne ek bar screen.
Okay.
Haha.
Okay, now is this site visible? All of you? Okay, happy mom saying yes. Okay. Thank you. So now on pharmasar.nomio.com site, what you have to do is you have to log in as a student. So you will have to create your account first in this. Okay. So let me just show you for Jatin.cet2. Okay. For Jatin.cet2. And I'll keep some password. In while keeping the password, you have to take care that it should be at least 8 characters. One digit is there, one lowercase letter is there, one uppercase letter is there, and one non-alphanumeric character should be there. That is any of these four. Okay, these three, sorry, star, dash, or hash. So I will keep the password here. I'll keep the email address as jatin.cet2@gmail.com. Again, okay, so I had typed the wrong mail. Okay, now I'll put that name over here, Jatin, and CET. I'll put city as Rajkot. We'll go for India, and I'll tick mark on whether I'm a robot or not, fire hydrant. So I'll select the fire hydrant. Okay, so now I create my new account on pharmasar.nomio.com. Now see, here I have created my account as a student. Since I want to be, I can be a faculty also in this pharmasar.nomio.com site, right? But currently you will be acting as a student. So you see, it is saying that an email has been sent. So I just click on continue. And I go to this my email account, and you can see there is a mail from Dr. Satya Prakash Singh, and that is via this pharmasar.nomio.com, right? And your account has been created. So I will click on this link. Once I click on this link, thanks Jatin, CET, your registration has been confirmed. I continue. Okay, so here I am on the Moodle of pharmasara.nomio.com, and when I click on this, I go to the FDP, I go to the course. This is particularly a course, right? This FDP, we have given it as a title called FDP on Moodle LMS for Patkar Vardhe College, Mumbai. But it is a course. So you use Moodle to upload your courses so that students can access the courses remotely from anywhere. Okay, so I'll click on it. And yes, one more thing has to be done. What we have done is, I have created my account on pharmasara.nomio.com site, but I have not yet registered for this course. So the enrollment options are visible. If I go down, the self-enrollment is available. So I will have to click on to enroll me. So I just click over here, and once I click over here, now I become a student of this particular course called FDP on Moodle LMS for Patkar Vardhe College, Mumbai. Until then, I would not have been a student. Okay. Until then, I would have only been a user of pharmasar.nomio.com site, but I would not have been a student of this particular course. So if you follow these steps, then you will be able to see this structure. On this left side, you can see the navigation part. You can see that you can see the participants from here. You can see the badges, competencies that you may need to complete, grades. Your grades may also be seen over here. Any general thing that you share, the faculty shares, teacher share. And there are folders of each day, okay. And you can see for each day there is a section. Day one there is a section. Day two there is a section. Day three there is a section. Day four is for self. Four and five is for self practice. And six and seven also is a section. Right now these sections are not yet populated. I'm not saying they're empty. They are not yet populated. So once we populate it, or once we make it visible, you will be able to see all the activities that are available in this. I'll just show you by teacher login also what activities are there. Before that, you will have to tick mark on these particular things. So see, this is a flyer. So if you've seen the flyer, you just simply tick mark over here. Okay. You click on it, or you don't click, you can manually control it from here. So you can manually complete it, right? These are the announcements page. This is the entry survey. What I've done is simply I've put the link of the form that you people had filled. This was the entry survey that we took before you could start this FDP. So we can know how many of you are aware with Moodle and all other things. Okay, so you can just simply click this also. Now see, clicking this is very important, because based on this completion, your other activities, for further activities will be available. So you see, this successful enrollment certificate will not be available until you complete some activities. So I completed these two activities. Let me just tick mark again, deselect these. Let's see what happens. I'll deselect everything. So you can see that entry survey, this activity, you will not get the enrollment certificate unless you complete this activity of entry survey. That is by manually clicking it. And even taking part in initial interaction. Okay. So I simply just click these two things, mark it available, that is mark it complete. Okay. Once I mark it complete, I also mark this. This is the installation video by Maulik sir. If you open it, it will open it in
YouTube site. Okay, Malik sir will also upload the Windows video. So I click on to it. Now see, this is the there is here. What does it mention? It says that the activity initial interaction is marked complete, right? But you cannot see where it is right now, and here it is in black. Okay, so I'll just simply go to the same site where I am using it as an teacher. Okay, so I'll do one thing. Just I'll simply log out of this. Sorry for that. I'll just log out from this, and I will again log in to this same site with my teacher login credentials. You may be even login as a guest if you try to log in. Okay, so now I got the wrong, still it is saying wrong password. Okay, let me go through another this thing. Here is the PharmaSal site. From this I will go. Okay, so there were some issues in login. I hope all of you are able to see the screen. Just any one of you, please reply by yes in audio.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. So this is now I have logged into the PharmaSal.gnomeo.com site as a teacher. Okay, and now I go to this FDP course. Now you can see I have marked this initial interaction as hidden from students. So what I will do is I will just first enable the turn editing on option. If I go to this gear icon, I will get to see many options, out of which I will click turn editing on. So once I click the turn editing on, the page will again be reloaded and I will get options in each and every this block. So you can see there are these options to edit, right? So what I will do is I just right now, since this was hidden, since this initial interaction was hidden, I will show it to you. I'll make it visible. So now as a student, you will be able to interact in this. Okay, so in the beginning, what you have to do is you have to introduce yourself and mention your name and designation. And let's see whether people have started doing it or not. So what does it say? The next session will start on Tuesday 9. Okay, let me try to enter the chat from here. Okay, so here I have started my chat session. Okay, and what will happen is if someone joins right now and if he sees this particular session, then he may be able to join with me. Otherwise he will not be able to join with me, right? If I close this window, you can see this window is there. If I close this particular window, then and after that someone logs in, then he will not be able to talk to me. Okay, so this is your course site, okay, in which you will have to do these activities. You will have to complete these activities by marking it okay, selecting it by which is called as marking for completion. Okay, then this is discussion forum for your queries and doubts. So whatever queries and doubts you have, I would suggest you put in this discussion forum. So this is in this particular FDP, we have not created any WhatsApp or Telegram group. And we want people to use more and more Moodle only. So that's why we have created a specifically discussion forum in which all of you can put your doubts. Let's see whether people have started putting their. Okay, still no discussion topic is there. No issue in that. Only put discussion for topic if and only if there are some doubts. Don't just put it for high hello purpose or just a simple meeting purpose. For that, you can use this initial interaction. Okay. So initial interaction is a chat window where you can chat. And discussion forum is specifically for solving queries and doubts. So whatever queries you have, please type into that. Please post your queries whenever you have your this queries. Our discussion forum moderators, Dr. Anup Sirbaya and Debayan sir, will be looking into it. And once you finish all these activities, your successful enrollment certificate will be generated. And now I can see most of you are online. Akarsa Samuel has been online within last 55 minutes. Karishma Jain, Neha Adnani, Ruchita ma'am, Rohini ma'am, Aarti ma'am, Pooja ma'am, Amol sir, Dipti ma'am. Most of you have. So as a teacher, I can see how many have logged in last 5 minutes. And this is a block. I will also show how to manage this kind of blocks as a teacher. Okay. So this can act as a, you know, motivation. If you want your students, even it acts as for monitoring whether all the students have logged in or not. Okay, so for each day, I'll just inform you about this also. In each day, you will have, you will see a quiz and a daily feedback. Without finishing these things, you will not be able to go ahead. Okay, so if any instructions are there from Malik sir, he will put in any of this folders, or he may make new folders and then make it visible to you. Right now these are hidden, so you are not able to see it in your site. And this quiz one will also be made online, which will be made visible by 9 p.m. today itself, and you will be able to put questions into it. Okay, and you will also have to give the daily feedback. Without completing these two, you will not be able to go ahead and complete the activities of day two. In day two, there will be a quiz and feedback. For every day, you will be having a quiz and feedback. One more thing is added in day three. In this peer interaction and peer evaluation, there will be one more thing added, and that is the this part, that is the workshop part, where you have already created your nominee.com site, right? But now you will have to get ready with your material, your maybe videos if you have selected to share it with students, your PDFs or docs or slides, and you will have to upload on to this. You will have to create a similar kind of structure for your course in that site, and you will have to submit that site, and so different things will be there. Okay, we'll later on I'll open it so that you can see what are there. Then similarly, there will be different things available for each day. So each day will have activity like a quiz and a feedback. Okay, without which you will not be able to go ahead. And so I hope you people have started generating the successful enrollment certificate. Yes, let me go to our site and let's see our this. Okay, so any issues are there? I'm on. Happy ma'am is saying yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Sir. Yeah, yeah. Can you explain again the discussion forum? I put the questions so the participant can know how can put the question on discussion forum and how to reply by us. So I have put one sample question.
Sure. Thank you for reminding me that, sir. Yeah. Okay, so I am going again back to this site, that is the pharmacer.nomi.com site, and in the course I can go to this part.
Yes, screen is not sharing.
Oh, sorry for that. Okay, thank you for reminding me, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have gone to the site, back to our Moodle site. In this, before day one, you get to see many activities, right? And these are the activities in which the discussion forum for queries and doubts is there. So you simply just click onto it. Okay. I'm opening it. And here you can see Dipti ma'am has created a topic. Maulik sir has created a topic. You can simply go to this button. In this discussion forum, there is this button called add a new discussion topic. So if you click onto it, you'll be able to add a new discussion topic. In subject, you have to ask your very short question. Okay.
Yeah, I have posted one question.
Yes, yes. And then
yeah, in that I also replied. Message. Yeah, I also replied on okay. that.
So you just simply say post to forum. So right now I'll not post any, I'll not make any post. I'll just go to Maulik sir's post. So to see the post, you can simply click onto it. Okay, once you click onto it, you'll get to see that this is the main question that Maulik sir has asked, that is the subject. This is the message that he has given, okay. And these are the details that this particular post is made by whom, on what date and time. And here you have some options like permanent link, so that this post can be shared with someone. You can edit the post for about 30 minutes. You will get the time to edit the post. Once you post, you will get about 30 minutes time to delete it. After 30 minutes, you will not be able to delete it. And you can even reply to a post.
Yeah.
So Maulik sir has replied with a post. Okay. Even you can reply. You just simply click on reply, and you will see the subject has already been put. You put the message, and you just post to forum. You can even put attachments. You can put files over here. Okay. So this is how, so what I suggest is, if you have any issues, what you do is you take the screenshot, okay, and upload that screenshot as a file to your discussion, to your query. So it will be much easier for us to, you know, understand your problem so that we can give you proper solution. And yes, I would also show you this part. See, this is the navigation part. Navigation is already there, available on left-hand side, okay. But the easiest navigation is this top navigation. This navigation shows you the whole, you can say, the branch in which you are currently logged into, or the branch of the course. So you can see this dashboard in this My Courses part. This is the course in which you are currently logged into. In which general section you are there. In the general section, there is a discussion forum. And in the discussion forum, there is a question asked, how to install Moodle on my PC or laptop or server. So that particular question is open currently. So that last part of this branch, of this whole branch, that is this last leaf, we can say, or the last name in this whole path, shows on which page you are. So suppose you want to go back directly to the main page, you just simply go to this. You click over here and you go to the main page, to the home page. So that will you will have to do continuously. Many times you will have to do to go back to home page. Okay. So I hope you people, most of you have logged into this site. Let me see how many participants are there. Okay, 94 participants are there, and you can see most of them are active. As a faculty, I can see, I can click over here, show all 95, and let's see who have been active since how many time. You can see the time also is visible to me. So at last, Akasha Samuel Mem was active before 1:08. Amol sir was active before 6 seconds. So these can be sorted, okay, according to last access. I will just click onto this last access. And status is also given, active or inactive. Okay, so most of them are there. All of them are active. That's very good. That's really good. Wow. Okay. So all 94 are active. Wow, that's very good. That's the best part of this activity. Okay. So I think that's it for the day. And let's see how many questions are there now. Let me stop my presenting. Okay. After typing the discussion topic, how do I send the message? Okay, you just have to post it. You just type the subject, type the message, and just post it. It will go to the discussion forum. Satyavan sir has asked that. Can you please show once again the enroll as a student's part? Roshan Mohanty. Roshan sir, I would show you the steps. Okay. Steps are, you go to pharmasar.nomio.com site. Okay. At this site, you go onto this site. You click on create new account. Once you go to create new account, you put your username, password, which you want to use as username. You put your email address, your first name, surname, city, and you click on create my account. Once you click on create my account, you will get a mail from Dr. Satya Prakash Singh via Moodle, and there will be a link of the site, and there will be a link to activate your account. Once you click onto this account, your link will be, your account, sorry, your account will be activated, and you will be able to access the pharmasar.nomio.com site. That was account creation on our pharmasar.nomio.com site. After you create the account, you have to enroll in that course. Which course? This particular course. The course entitled as FDP on Moodle LMS. Okay. I'm once again sorry, I had not been sharing my screen. Yes. So once you put all these details on pharmasar.nomio.com site, you will be able to create your account. And after you create your account, you'll get a mail from Satya Prakash Singh sir. You click on that link that is given to you, you activate your account, and then you can log into this particular site. Once you log in, you will have to join this course. You will have to say enroll me in this course. Open that course and click on the enroll me button. Then you will be able to see this structure that I am showing you, this particular structure. Okay, that structure will be visible once you will be able to easily join it. Again, if you are not able to join it, don't worry. This video that is being recorded by your ma'am will be shared with you. You can refer that video. There is another video that I have already sent to you people. You can also use that video to see how to log into this particular site. Okay. Okay. So am I clear with that, Roshan Mohanty? Okay, Sopan sir is asking how much internet speed is required for this course. I'm going very slow behind you. Sopan sir, don't worry. If you are a tech savvy person, or if you are aware of clicking onto links, on aware of to using websites on Moodle, you will be easily on your mobile, then you will be easily be able to open it in your mobile, and just by simple clicks and that, you will be able to go ahead. You can even watch this recording of this video. Okay. Okay, sir, please show your screen with discussion forum and show the post icon. Okay, sure, I will show the post icon. So I go to this discussion forum in the course. In that course, okay, many of you have put the post. You simply go to add a new discussion topic. And this is to create a discussion. Right, you may even answer to someone. We are not making it compulsory for you to only make a new discussion. You can even answer someone. If you know the answer, it will be much better. That would be peer interaction and peer learning. I would encourage that. So you can even answer someone question if you know. You put subject, okay, you put some message, and then you simply, if you want to share something, you put your file over here. You can drag and drop it. And then you just simply post to forum. No need to select this display period and other things right now. Okay, you can just simply post it to forum. You click on to post it to forum and your message will be posted. Okay, so there are n number of posts currently, so I don't want to post anything. Very good. I can see many of you have posted over here. Let me see other questions. Internet speed won't affect much. Rima ma'am has received the certificate. Very good. Okay. Yes, in discussion forum, you need to ask only questions related to gnome.com or our subject also. No issue. You can even ask your questions related to this particular pharmacy.gnome.com site also, if you are facing any issues with that. For example, if your certificate is not being generated, your photo is not coming on your site. Okay, for that, thank you for asking this question, Usha ma'am. I'll just show one more thing which I have forgotten. Once you become the user of this particular site, then you go to this part and edit your profile. I would urge you people to edit your profile, and as I have added my photo, you can even add your photo. You just simply by clicking onto it, you can change the photo. Okay, this is the profile. Once I click on edit profile, I will be able to edit my profile. So it would be much better if you can add your details like picture, your full name and other things. Okay, your country and all those things, and then you can update your profile. Okay, so I would recommend you people to add your photo also, so that it gets reflected in your certificate. Okay, if you want a certificate with a photo. Okay, Usha ma'am has edited the profile. Very good. Okay, so any question remaining that I'm unable to tackle right now? Can you just yes, if any question is unanswered, you can resend it. I'm watching the this meet, that is the
side by side. I have uploaded the presentation and download link file to the day one resource.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. And quiz will quiz is also uploaded, right, Malik sir? So
yeah, quiz is also uploaded. It will show after end of the 15 minutes after the end of the session.
Wow, that's good. So best of luck to all for the quiz. And any other questions? So last call for questions, then we will wind up this session. Yes? Any other questions remaining from my side to answer or from my team to answer? Please make it available in chat. Okay, trying to add your photo, but not able to. I would suggest try changing the browser. There may be some issues with the browser. Okay. Will the quiz appear on the day one activities? Yes. Each day there will be a quiz. Quiz statement, can you repeat, please? .NET in net issues. Okay. Quiz, in this quiz, you will have every day you will have a quiz which will be activated after your FDP session gets over. So once this session gets over, after 15 minutes, your quiz will be uploaded. Okay. You will get to see. Right now, as a student, you will not be able to see. See, this is, let me show you. Let me log into this particular thing as a student. Okay. Okay. So now you can see my screen also, right? See, I have logged in as a...
Jadin sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I have. Can I open the quiz so students participants can view it?
Just a minute, sir. We will open it once this this session gets completed.
Yeah,
so they will able to view it. Don't worry. I will make it visible.
Okay. Okay.
So here you can see, as a student, I have logged in, and I can click on this courses. I click on to my course, this particular FDP course. And here these activities are in general section. This is the general section. And this is the day one section. If I go to this folder will open in a new page. And sir has put a PPT. And if I again click on to this day one, I will be shown in day one which all things are there. Okay. And if I click on to this main home page, I will be taken to the home page of the course.
Yeah, download.
Okay. So here in this day one itself, you will get to see the quiz and day one feedback. Okay. So that is your task. You may complete it by tomorrow. Okay. We'll be giving 24 hours deadline. In some cases, deadlines will be of 48 hours also, so don't worry in that. Okay. So right now, as a student, I am not able to see the quiz, but once I activate it, you will be able to see it. Okay. So let's call it as an end of the day. And not able to upload photos. Swati ma'am, are you able to upload the photo now?
No, sir, I'm not able to upload the photo.
Okay. Did you try changing the browser?
Okay. I should use another browser.
Try it with another browser. That may help. Okay.
Okay.
Check that if there is an issue with the browser itself. Okay.
Okay.
Or the photo size may be an issue also. Okay. The photo type. Try to see what kind of images it is accepting. It may happen that your image that you are trying to put, it may not be able to accept it. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Sujata ma'am is asking how to generate enrollment certificate. Ma'am, you will be able to generate the enrollment certificate once you complete all the general activities. Only then general enrollment certificate will get activated, and then if you click onto it, you will be able to download it. Okay, it is not giving me any option to browse the photograph file. Let's go to photograph. Many people are having the photograph issue. So, okay, let me go to my student account. So right now I am in student account. Okay, I will go to this part. I will go to profile part. And I will have to click on to edit profile. Okay, so see, this new picture part is there, right? This thing should come. user picture. This user picture section is below this general section. If you go to your profile, then in this edit profile section, you will have this five subsections. So in this general, if you open this, you will have your name, surname, email address, city, and other descriptions about you. And below that, you will have user picture. You just click onto it, and here you have to upload your picture. Okay. Once you upload your picture over here, your picture, and you and then you update your profile, your picture will be available, visible. Okay. Am I clear with that, everyone? Okay, Gaurav sir is facing a problem in enrolling. What enrolling problem did you face, sir? Can you just tell me what issue was that exact problem? How many attempts? Aniket sir is asking how many attempts? You will get only one attempt, sir. Pooja ma'am is saying got certificate as well as uploaded pic. That's good. Great. Okay. Usha ma'am, I hope you got the user picture option, how to upload the picture, from where to upload the, it is below the general section only. Okay. Jeteshri ma'am is asking, could you explain the quiz part once again? Okay. Quiz part, that quiz part will be MCQ based quiz. Okay, that will be available in day one. Within the 15 minutes, once this session gets completed, you will be able to see it. So you, once you refresh the page, that will come. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yes. Hello, sir. Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Sir, I'm facing the problem. It's showing that ad is blocked or something like that.
Yes, ma'am. That's what I was saying, that these issues will come if your browser blocks the ad. Ad blocker. If has got ad blocker inside it, then it will not allow you. So do one thing. I would suggest search on the internet, search on Google, how to disable the ad blocker, right? And try to do that. If that is also not happening, try to. I would suggest try to just disable. If you have antivirus, then try to disable it for some time. And if that is also not possible, then you. Please try to use another browser, because if you don't disable the ad block in your browser, until then you won't be able to view this site. It may appear for some time, then it will go.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Anikat sir is saying right click on ad block and click on disable on this site. That's right. You can simply do it like that way also, but in some browsers it's not that easy, so you'll have to take care for that.
Okay.
I have logged in using different email other than Gmail. No issue, Gaurav sir. You can use any email. You can log in this portal with any email. No issue there. So yes, any other issues? Any issues for registration or any other issues? Otherwise, we will wind up. Gaurav sir, what did you want to want me to explain? Yes, Gaurav sir, you are asking. Please explain again. What exactly you want me to explain again? Can you just elaborate? Okay, how to generate certificate? Okay. Okay, so see, here I am in my student account, right? I go to the main page. I have to do some interaction. So, okay, I had done some one chat. Okay, so that because of that, I'm able to mark it. And discussion forum activity has to be done, but that is not mandatory for successful. So I click onto it. Now you can see it is telling get certificate. So click onto that get certificate and a window will open. Now if you have disabled a pop-up, see, this is a pop-up, right?
So if you have disabled the pop-up in your browser, then this, even this will not open. So you please take care that you have not disabled any pop-ups in your browser. Okay. So you can see the certificate is there. Right now, we have not put the image over here. If we put the image, then that will also be visible in your certificate. Okay. And you can simply print it, or you can save it or download it. Okay. So I hope I have made it clear how to generate this enrollment certificate, right? Requirements for certificate will be available beneath the certificate. It will be written beneath the certificate. Let me show you. You will not be able to generate the certificate unless you complete these two activities. By manually clicking the entry survey part, by manually completing it, marking it complete, and by taking part in the initial interaction. Unless you make any chat, you will not be able to generate the certificate. Okay, so these are some of the restrictions that we have put, so you don't generate the certificate directly. Okay. Show me how to fill the participant introduction columns to be filled in by sharing your screen. Okay, how to fill the participant introduction columns. Okay, that is the chat. Satyavan sir, you want me to show how to do the chat? Is it so?
No, sir. It is that I'm not getting the certificate. It says the initial interaction you have not done. So I'm not understanding how to fill those columns because A, B, C, D. So how do I put N, I, L, I, M, A, my name and Prabhu and all that, you know?
Okay, so, did you complete this profile part? Editing your profile part?
Yes, sir. I have.
Okay. So once you have completed your profile part, then what you have to do is you go to this interaction part, initial interaction part. I click onto this initial interaction part and click here to enter the chat now. Okay. So currently these persons are active. You can see
so
these.
I have already chatted. I have already put something on the discussion forum.
Not discussion forum, ma'am. This is interaction. This is
initial.
Yes, initial interaction is the chat.
Okay.
So okay. That's why in the beginning I told not to put anything in the discussion forum, only in the chat. You can. Okay. So these many people are there. So I will just say hi all.
Okay. Thank you.
Once you send this, you will be able to. Once you complete these two activities, manual marking of that the form. Okay, that we had given you, that you already, people, you have filled, that you just have to manually complete it, marking it and entering into a chat with someone. If there is no one with the chat, then also don't worry. Once you are posted in the chat, that's it. Your contribution will be automatically considered. And then automatically you will be able to, this link will be activated for you. So you click onto this link and then you generate a certificate. You see, it has been issued. Since I had generated it before some time, it is showing me that it has been issued. Okay. So I hope that is it for the day. And let's make it, call it end of the day. And if I'm unable to answer any of the questions, please feel free to ask it in the discussion forum. Our DFMs will be there. We also will try to answer as much as possible. Gaurav sir is saying, I got certificate as a teacher. Don't worry, sir. We'll just take care to that. We'll edit it and change that that part. Quiz. Yes, Tipti ma'am. Quiz will be activated within 15 minutes. Okay, sir. Okay, all then. Again, Usha ma'am is asking how to generate a certificate. Usha ma'am, you'll have to complete these two activities. Okay. One is to manually marking the form part, and the second is to taking part in the chat.
Okay, these two are at least required. Okay, so let's call it okay. End of the day, and let's hope for the other questions to be in the discussion forum.
Okay.
Yes, Gunjan ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Good evening, everyone.
Okay.
I think okay. So we'll quickly go through a quick recap of what we have learned today. First, the session was taken by Maulik sir, where he have very nicely explained of how to install Moodle, what is the course, what is plugin. He have also given example of report plugin. Then what is the role of teacher and student. Also explain what we have to install for admin sign when it is a Linux server or Windows PC or Mac. After explaining all these things, the session was taken over by Jatin sir, where he have explained us how to log in as admin user, and very importantly, how to become student on FDP on Moodle Element for Patkar Verde College on farmersr.nomio.com, which is very important. We all have to do it today. He have also explained us about all the activities that we are going to do in the next sessions. Very importantly, everyone have to mark the activities which they have completed. For example, if you have completed the entry survey, you have to mark it. And very important, there is also discussion forum where you can post your queries and your doubt. You can also take a screenshot of your doubt and you can post over there. I am sure sir will handle and address all the doubt. And every day you will be given a quiz and a feedback. All the participants are requested to fill the feedback and complete the quiz so that they can go on to the next session on the second day. I would like to take this opportunity to thank our today's speaker, Professor Jatin Ambasana and Professor Maulik Trivedi. Sir, this was truly a very interactive and informative session. I'm sure all our participants are going to enjoy all our further sessions. I would also like to thank Dr. Anup Kumar Sirbeya and Professor Debayan Bhattacharya for handling the discussion forum. I would also take this opportunity to thank all the participants for their active participation in today's session. The invitation of tomorrow's session will be sent to all the participants in your mailbox by tomorrow morning. Thank you so much. Stay home, stay safe.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye for today.